Kia of West Palm Beach Studio.
We want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
This is 97.9 WRMF Palm Beach.
It's time to wake up and let the weirdness begin. It's the KBJ show. To start your morning.
Kevin is the host.
And his skin pigment is whiter than Casper the Ghost.
Virginia.
Sounds like this.
Nickname Vicious Beast.
So don't get her pissed.
It's Jason. Talks like a spaz.
And he loves to talk about Bigfoot and stats. So get ready. Here we go. You're listening to 97.9 with the KBJ show.
Oh, yeah, baby. Hello and welcome to the KBJ show. Here we go.
Here we go.
Thursday. Oh, yeah. Another beautiful day here. How the heck is everybody today?
We are good. How the heck are you?
I think I'm doing all right. I think I'm doing okay for Thursday here.
You're breathing?
I'm breathing. I'm doing all right.
Woke up feeling better than P. Diddy, like Kesha would say.
Yeah, I wonder how he's doing on a day-to-day basis. I don't think people even know where Diddy is right now.
Great question.
Yeah.
Where's Diddy? How he doing?
He's hanging out with Armie Hammer somewhere.
Yeah.
What's so unbelievable to me with the Diddy story, and it's exhausting, honestly. I'm loving it, but it's exhausting because unlike the Jeffrey Epstein story, everyone's talking. Everyone's talking. And no one talked in the Jeffrey Epstein thing, which is what we wanted. And me just trying to stay on top of all the Diddy allegations and stories every day, it's been exhausting.
But thank goodness everybody's talking. Because this is what should happen when you're dealing with deviants.
Yeah.
We don't keep the secrets of deviants. I don't care if you're Diddy or somebody who, you know, lives on your block. We don't keep the secrets of deviants.
So let me just tell you, it's going to be a very active day today because we've got a lot of stuff.
I love it.
We need to cover. Yeah, it's some good stuff.
Spill the juice.
Oh, going to be a very juicy Thursday here. Get ready. Sop it up with a biscuit. Coming up in a couple of minutes as well, going to be going over what is on our mind. And for me, remember on my mind just last week, told you about that crazy nightmare I had where I was in a submerged car and I woke up gasping for breath.
Yes.
Well, I mean, this whole bridge story has kind of, you know, kind of resurfaced. People are like, oh my gosh, Kevin, it's almost like that was part of the premonition. I don't even know. Because they found, you know, there was one car that was submerged that had two people in it.
Oh.
And unfortunately, that is the story here in South Florida. We had two stories. When I woke up from that dream, boom, I go right out and I see two stories of people pulled out of water. So I actually have some life-saving information. What we all have to know. Had that on my mind for you next on the KBJ Show.
Feeling my way through the darkness. Guided by a beating heart. I can't tell where the journey will end, but I know where to start. They tell me I'm too young to understand. They say I'm caught up in a dream. Well, life will pass me by if I don't open up my eyes. So that's fine by me. So wake me up when it's all over. Stay forever this young, not afraid to close my eyes. Life's a game made for everyone, and love is the prize. So wake me up when it's all over, when I'm wiser and I'm older. All this time I was finding myself, and I didn't know I was lost. So wake me up.
you thinking about today, Jay Bird?
Well, we've got our Weird and Whatever podcast tonight, 6 p.m. KVJ YouTube page. We'd love to have all y'all show up and get weird with us. We got some fun stuff we're going to be talking about. Here's one of the topics, and tell me how you'd handle this, Virginia. My daughter is being bullied at school, dun, 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 by a ghost.
You know what? Remember those tabloids they used to have at the grocery store? The
yes.
News of the whatever it was, World or the Weird or whatever that one was. It had Bat Boy on it.
Weekly World News.
Weekly World News. That sounds like a headline from Weekly World News.
Well, here's another headline that we're going to be discussing. I think my dad is a lizard person.
Oh, my gosh.
Signed, Caitlin Ralston.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, so we're going to be talking a bunch of paranormal and odd things tonight, so we'd love to have you. 6 p.m.
Okay.
And if you can't make it, it will always be on our YouTube page.
Yeah,
so
that's right.
This will be episode 4 of our season.
Okay. Very cool. All right.
That's all I got, just promotion.
Yeah.
Good stuff. I love it.
All right, what you got on your mind today, Virginia?
Well, I'm super excited because I think today after the show, we talked about doing this. We're going to tape a little segment with one of our KVJ Nationers. Her name is Lynn, and she's got a big weekend coming up because she is going to meet her blood sibling for the first time as a woman in her 40s. How cool is that?
It's cool. Mm-hmm.
She was adopted from Vietnam. She came over to this country as an infant, not knowing her family, not knowing where she came from, and connected because of those 23andMe, Ancestry.com. Yeah. Found she has a brother who's living in Florida. And they're going to meet for the first time this weekend. How cool is that?
It's cool
stuff.
I'm so excited. So, yeah, we'll hear her story hopefully tomorrow on the show and then get a full wrap-up from her next week. I'm just so excited. I love long-lost siblings. I really wish I would have a long-lost sibling.
You don't have enough?
No, I want more.
All right.
That'd be so cool to find out, you know, that you had a sibling that you knew nothing about, and then you go meet them, and you love them, and you're just like them. That'd be awesome.
You find out you have one, but dun, 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 it's a man. You have a brother.
Or a lizard person.
Or you find out it's Panda. We're actually siblings.
Now that's twisted.
That story has happened.
That story has happened. And people were like, oh, we were so in love. We were so connected. We loved all the same stuff. Yeah, because y'all are siblings.
Crazy, right?
I feel like I would know. I would feel, it would feel off.
How would you know what you don't know?
I know, but I feel like there's, it feels weird, like a cat to water. It doesn't feel normal.
You just made out with this hot chick, you'd be like, I don't know, it feels like my sister.
Yes, okay. I feel like I would.
You would have that premonition.
I think my stomach would go, this don't feel natural, this feels wrong.
Right. Yeah.
I would hope that's what would happen.
You would hope. Yeah. But what if you were just in it,
you
loved her and you didn't want to give her up and you're like, I don't care.
I can't believe how much she looks like me.
Yeah, that would be I guess that's the decision they have to make sometimes is, I know that she's my sister, but oh man, it just feels so right.
If you didn't know and you never grew up with each other and you met each other in your 30s and you fell madly in love,
yeah,
and you're talking 3 years in and that's your soulmate, and then you find out it's your sister.
That'd be tough.
Oh my gosh.
Just don't have kids and keep you a secret.
What?
Keep loving who you love.
You say just keep going for it.
Yeah, just keep going for it. Just don't have kids, because I think the kid can come out with two heads.
I think that's technically illegal. If you know about it, I don't think you're allowed to do that.
I mean, what are they going to do?
Yeah, there are laws against it.
There's laws against it.
But aren't there other crimes they need to be looking after?
I don't know, man. If we let that happen, do we kind of let the gates open for a lot of...
You didn't know when you got married. I don't think you should be penalized.
South Florida's jacked up as it is. Can you imagine if we were all then inbred?
Yeah, I don't think that.
I mean, you add that to the mix?
I don't think that's the right
move.
I don't
think we can survive that.
Virginia's over here trying to make this
love
story.
You love who you love.
Incest.
I can't help it.
It's an odd thing to stand for, isn't it?
Didn't know it was your sibling when you married him. I don't think it's your fault.
If it became normalized, I think we'd be heading in a wrong direction.
Yeah.
Just a gut instinct.
Yeah. You know, TikTok could do it, though.
You're right.
Yeah. Kissing sisters would be a hashtag, and next thing you know, it goes viral, and everybody's doing it.
Oh, boy.
Everybody's wanting to date their brother or sister. Oh, man. TikTok could do it.
What's on your mind, Kev?
That bridge story that's going on in Maryland, because it's just all over the news. It's about a third of all news time, I would guess, just from what I have seen over the last day. The latest on that. They've kind of called off the search and rescue part of it, and now they're just trying to clean up and obviously find the bodies of the missing men. Two of them were found recovered in a pickup truck that had gone down. These are the people that were working on the bridge when it was hit by that big old tanker and the freighter, I guess, and brought the bridge down. So four more workers still missing as of last night. And they're kind of looking at the cargo ship called the Dolly. And they said it actually suffered from a severe electrical problem for days before it lost power during its trip out of the Maryland Harbor. There's going to be some negligence, I think, that's going to be found with this story.
Well, if you know that you're having problems, you fix the problems before you go coasting down the river.
It's kind of like, hey, Bob, you got a flat tire. Cool, let's go cruising.
Believe me, I know that move. It doesn't work out.
No, it doesn't. The container ship had 56 containers of hazardous materials as well, some of which were breached after the bridge fell, and now there is a nice sheen on the water.
Oh, oh cool.
We're going to deal with that as well.
Mm-hmm. Environmental crisis on top of it.
it's not good, yeah. 23 people were on the Dolly, two of whom are pilots. I think some of those crew members, I thought I heard yesterday on one of the news reports that they're still on the boat.
So I'm going to ask maybe a dumb question. Is there any chance that the people they're looking for could be alive, or are they pretty much now it's gone to...
They've said it's not realistic.
Yeah, okay.
Because of the water temperature itself, the fact that they haven't resurfaced, hypothermia at the very least, even if they were floating somewhere, would have taken them out by now. So unless they somehow swam to shore and they're there, which they're not expecting that at all. They say the bridge disaster could cost insurers $4 billion. That was that mistake. $4 billion.
So when they say a number like that, and I know you're not going to know the answer, so I apologize for even asking this. On your average, how much does that go up for your average person? When you say people got to pay for that and all that?
Yeah, I don't know exactly who's going to front the cost of that. It could just be coming out of the pocket of the federal government.
Got ya.
But, you know, taxes are there, and that's always something to consider. But that's where some of your tax dollars will go, is to repairing the damage done from that. So it's expensive, I guess. But the whole concept of a bridge coming down like that, now luckily they were able to warn drivers. They pretty much had the bridge cleared except for the workers that were on there. But it is really, especially on social media, brought out people who have what they call gephyrophobia. Anybody know what gephyrophobia is?
Is it a fear of driving over a bridge?
It is a fear of driving over a bridge. Virginia, you get our first gold star of the day.
Yeah, I think like when something like this happens, you can't help but think about those poor people when you're driving over any bridge.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's so top of mind, and as you're going over the bridge, you're looking for freighters.
Yeah, well, this is, you know, what has kind of gotten in people's mind. And, you know, so far, ships have destroyed at least 35 major bridges since 1960. 18 of those were in the U.S. Yesterday on the After the Show, we were talking about the Skyway Bridge in Tampa that came down in 1980, killing, I think, 35 people. And that one. And so, you know, stories like that is kind of what gives people the gephyrophobia. And we got bridges all over South Florida.
I'm not going to lie. I'm not a huge fan of bridges. Not my favorite thing to drive
You've
over.
Never liked driving over
no.
bridges. You've always said that. Your mama didn't like it.
Yeah.
Well, it sucks if you're scared. If you're not a fan of heights. And there's some bridges that can get up there, man. And then a boat's coming and you're stuck up there.
That Skyway Bridge, the one that you're talking about in Tampa.
Yeah.
Didn't that one go like super high?
Yeah, it was awesome. It was huge. It was huge.
Pretty high.
It's rebuilt now, but yeah, in 1980, it was huge.
So. There's like one in Charleston that is like so scary looking, and I'm not afraid of bridges. But like, there's some scary bridges.
And when you're stuck and you see four boats coming, you're like, oh boy, we're going to be here for a minute.
Yeah, right. So on our Instagram and Facebook, we were asking if you had the gephyrophobia. How do you cope? What do you do? And I'll let you know what some people on social media said they were doing. But this is valuable information that I really think everybody should know. because whether it's a bridge or not, there's so many bodies of water here and so many stories. Just last week when I had that nightmare of I was in a submerged car and I was like trying to breathe and get out, I woke up in just like a panic. And then I saw two stories of people that had driven into either canals, rivers, whatever it might be, and were not able to get out of their car. They say you got about a minute.
Oh boy.
When it happens, typically where the engine is, the front of the car starts to go down first. Usually the back end of the car is second. But I saw this yesterday. The rules you need. Now, they talked about those little hammers you can put on keychains to bust out a window if you have to. But apparently, these are the rules that you need if you find yourself in a submerged car. This could be life-saving information. This comes from Douglas Bishop of United Search Corps.
There's four letters that everyone needs to remember right now watching this, and that's S-W-C-O, and that's seatbelt, window, children, out. You got to take your seatbelt off first. You can't do anything. You can't save your life with your seatbelt on. You immediately, as soon as you can, you put the window down so your electronics don't fail and so that pressure doesn't prohibit your window from opening. So seatbelt, window, open your window, and children are first. You get to your children first. Once your children are out, then you are out, because once you're out of a vehicle, you're not getting back into that vehicle to rescue anybody. So S-W-C-O, seatbelt, window, children, out.
Okay, got that?
Swaku.
It's tough.
Swaku.
Yeah.
Seatbelt, window, children.
Just say it, swaku.
Out. All right.
So cool. So
cool. Dude, I'm not going to remember that. Yeah. There's no effing way.
Don't feel like that's helping you.
I was trying to memorize the word, but so cool isn't the best, most.
It doesn't roll off the tongue, Kevin.
No, it doesn't. It's probably not going to help. Probably not going to help, but yeah, take off your seatbelt, get the window down as soon as you can, get the kids out of the car, and then you leave the vehicle. That's how it goes.
Yeah, man, that window, to me, that's the one that's going to get you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, getting that window down is the key.
I'll bite my seatbelt off if I have to.
That seems like a futile effort.
Good luck on that. Can we get a seatbelt up here, see how long it takes for Jaber to gnaw through it? Keep in mind, you got 1 minute.
He'll be here next Wednesday. Still trying to chew.
Can Jaber eat through a seatbelt in 1 minute?
That one tooth that broke last year is going to break again.
Yep. What, you don't think I could do it? Yeah. Give me that seatbelt.
We just need a seatbelt here, stat.
Denny's.
Bird's got 1 minute.
I'm going to bust out one of my teeth.
I have a seatbelt, actually, at home. Panda has a belt made out of a seatbelt.
Bring it.
Bring it in. See if Bird can gnaw through it in a minute.
1 minute. That's it.
1 minute. That's it.
World record Wednesday.
Or else we get to drown you. All right. So if you've got that gyrophobia, fear of bridges, tell us about it. What do you do to cope? I'll let you know what people on TikTok are doing next.
The KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF.
Z-O-O-M-T-A-N. I was tan last summer, now I'm pale again. I need a little bit of help to be ready for the beach soon. Tan puts some within my reach. Brown as a biscuit for $9.99. ZoomTan.com for a limited time.
ZoomTan, $9.99. ZoomTan.com.
All copper tans are now Zoom tans. Go to ZoomTan.com/radio for $9.99 offer.
Ulta Beauty's semi-annual beauty event is happening now. Unleash your love for beauty with 50% off daily beauty steals on hair, skin, makeup, and fragrance. Shop your favorite brands like Tarte and Fenty Beauty by Rihanna. Plus, grab perfect hair care pairs from brands like Redken and Olaplex. And check out new arrivals from brands like Charlotte Tilbury and Dyson. Shop the Ulta Beauty semi-annual beauty event online, in-store, or try pickup today. Now through March 28th. Ulta Beauty, the possibilities are beautiful. Conditions apply.
Rosalitas!
Spice up your life with the best, most authentic Tex-Mex grill in Palm Beach at Rosalitas in Lantana. They welcome you to the award-winning restaurant with only the finest meats, poultry, and fish dishes. A family-run restaurant since 1994. The minute you walk in the door of Rosalitas, you'll smell the aroma of delicious fajitas, burritos, or enchiladas made fresh to order. Their friendly staff is always ready to serve you with your favorite Tex-Mex dish, such as carne asada, fish tacos, baby back ribs, or Santa Fe salad, spinach, and chicken enchiladas. Or you can always go the lighter side with a tortilla soup and a taco salad. Rosalita's is open daily, starting with happy hour from 11 till 7, lunch and dinner. And there's always something fun going on at Rosalita's, with karaoke on Tuesdays and Fridays and live music on Saturdays. What are you waiting for? Come and spice up your life. 561-964-5747 on the corner of Lantana and Congress.
Come and spice up your life at Rosalita's. Rosalita's.
Joint pain. It's something that can literally stop us in our tracks. At QC Kinetics, we offer a revolutionary specialized course of treatment perfected over 10 years that can eliminate your pain. Our regenerative therapies actually repair damaged tissue, restoring the joint and eliminating the pain, not masking it with drugs or risky invasive surgery. If you suffer with joint pain, arthritis, age, degeneration, or a sports injury, and have been told you need knee, hip, shoulder, or back surgery, QC Kinetics offers revolutionary non-surgical solutions with actual regrowth of your own tissue with no downtime and long-lasting results. Call right now and set up your free examination with one of our highly specialized doctors at one of our six leading-edge clinics in Palm Beach, Broward, and Miami. Experience VIP medical care at its best. Call right now and see how you can get your first treatment free. Call 800-292-3979. That's 800-292-3979. 800-292-3979.
The Jeep Celebration event is going on right now with exceptional offers on a wide selection of Jeep brand vehicles. If you're looking to supercharge your next adventure, look no further than America's best-selling plug-in hybrid, the Jeep Wrangler 4xe. Or choose the luxurious Grand Cherokee or Grand Cherokee 4xe. All celebrations must come to an end, so hurry and visit Jeep.com or your local Jeep brand dealer for great deals during the Jeep Celebration event. Based on 2022 CYQ4 sales, J.D. Power retail sales data. Jeep is a registered trademark.
The school district of Palm Beach County is your best choice.
It's time to step into kindergarten. Parents, the school district of Palm Beach County is now enrolling kindergarten students for the upcoming school year. Register now at palmbeachschools.org/kindergarten. Find out when to attend your school's kindergarten roundup and how to get your free kindergarten readiness kit. That's palmbeachschools.org/kindergarten.
Get ready for an out-of-this-world space adventure inspired by NASA missions with space explorers, The Infinite, at the Kravis Center, June 4th through September 2nd. Embark on the International Space Station and join the crew of astronauts for a spacewalk that'll leave you changed forever. Don't miss the chance to discover this unique immersive experience. The Infinite, June 4th through September 2nd at the Kravis Center.
Want your child to go to summer camp, but afraid you can't afford it? Did you know you can apply for one of the more than 3,000 summer camp scholarships available right now for Palm Beach County children? Now is the time to apply for camp scholarships. The deadline is April 12th. To learn more, go to everyparentpbc.org/camp. That's everyparentpbc.org/camp. This message brought to you by Children's Services Council of Palm Beach County.
Introducing Sparked Energy by Dunkin', available in two full-on delicious flavors, Berry Burst and Peach Sunshine. Drop by or order ahead on the Dunkin' app. Fruit-flavored, contains 0% fruit juice.
I'm Mark Anajar.
I'm Glenn Levine.
I'm Ellie Anajar.
Together, we're Anajar and Levine.
If you've been hurt in a car crash, we'll fight to get you the maximum compensation you deserve.
Call Anajar and Levine for your free consultation. 1-800-747-FREE.
In office, West Palm Beach.
They keep it real. The KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF.
Well, with the story pretty much front and center on the news of a bridge collapse in Baltimore, a lot of people were taking to social media to talk about their own little phobias that they have of driving over bridges. Technically, it is called gyrophobia, and here's how some of them are coping.
Just in case the bridge collapses and you need an escape rope.
What? That is absolutely terrifying. That bridge up in Maryland, like, just collapsed like Legos.
No! Please, please, please. Where's my crystal?
I'm driving over a bridge right now, and I'm scared as hell!
I'm not gonna look. I'm not gonna look. I can't look.
Yeah, some people actually are that way. I have seen people I've been riding in a car with, and they will lift their feet off of the floorboard for whatever reason. I guess they feel like they're adding more weight to the car. I'm like, what are you doing? Like, I don't know. It's just a weird thing I do when I go over bridges.
Minus the overtalk or the over-the-top TikTok reaction, I do have what they're talking about. And I try to do is I will do anything in my power to avoid going over the bridge, meaning I'll take a longer alternate route.
Okay.
That's why I have to leave early sometimes.
Just doing whatever you can to drive all the way around it.
Whatever you can do to avoid that, yes.
Okay.
Because you all don't want me over a bridge anyway, trust me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, some of the comments that we got, like Douglas had said, yeah, I don't have a phobia, but my wife does, and it still has to go back to 1980 and that bridge collapse, the Skyway Bridge in Tampa. So, I mean, if you grew up as a kid and you knew that story, you know, it's something like that. You think about when you were a kid, how many phobias you adopted, and you
sure.
want to go to the root of why you today as an adult have a certain fear. It likely is something that you saw in your childhood you couldn't understand or comprehend.
We didn't take many vacations as a family, but I remember one, we were going to, what's the big theme park in Tampa? The
Busch Gardens.
Busch Gardens, yeah. And there is a, I'm not sure if this is the bridge you're talking about, because this was like the mid-80s, and it was a long bridge that was so many miles, and my dad realized right when he got on the bridge that we were on E, on empty, and my mom did not take that well, and it was a hairy ride, y'all. Oh my gosh. So to your point, yeah, you kind of get it from your parents.
You do.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. A lot of it will be that.
A lot of your anxiety will come from parents, and parents who are always nervous, always worried, always anxious. The kids grow up seeing that, feed off of it, and then they become adults that are always worried, anxious, nervous.
My mom was given the TikTok overreaction before the TikTok overreaction was even famous.
Yeah.
When that was going down.
Okay, imagine if she had a TikTok page. How well it would have done.
She'd have been a star.
Your mom would rule TikTok.
She'd have been a star.
She did not take that well.
She'd have been a star. Joan said, I take my seatbelt off and I roll down the window.
Okay.
And other people were saying that, you know, in case they do wind up in the water and they need to get out of the vehicle.
He's ready.
That's a good call.
Yeah, I don't know if that's how you're supposed to handle it, but...
But look, it gives you a little peace of mind. At least you're not as panicked as you're driving over it because you've done everything you can. You're already two letters into that word I forgot already.
Mm-hmm.
What was it? Schlep?
It is. No, you're just remember this word, Swoko.
Swoko. You're already two letters into Swoko.
Swoko.
It's true. It's
seatbelt, window... If you don't have any kids, this is perfect.
Crap your pants.
Children out.
Hope you don't die on impact.
Mm-hmm. Ryan said, yeah, every day I have a fear that I'm going to wind up in dead stop traffic on the Roosevelt Bridge.
Oh, Ryan.
Yeah. When you got a tall bridge like that and you don't like bridges, I mean, imagine if you are stuck in traffic and you're sitting there for a while.
No, so if Ryan really has a terrible fear and he has to drive that for work every day, and that's the only way to get to work, that sucks, man. I get it.
Yeah. A lot of people are talking about how they will drive 20 minutes out of their way to drive around something like the Roosevelt Bridge in Stewart.
There you go, Bird. That's your people.
I will leave 30 minutes early before an event.
Yeah. Well, how do you cope? If you want to chime in, you can go to our Instagram and also to our Facebook pages. Got the thread going there right now. Well, Jaybird has gotten his blood test results back.
Okay. Are we pregnant?
That's what we're going to find out, hopefully. Gosh, that would be amazing.
Oh, we need a KVJ baby. Baby Lachlan's getting old. It's time for a new, fresh baby.
Okay. All right. We'll see what the doctor had to say about that. And is Jaybird going to be able to indulge in Virginia's homemade chocolates?
Yes, I made these. Me and Rocco made homemade peanut butter cups.
Okay. All right. So Jaybird hopefully will be able to try them and give you his thoughts on how good they are or not coming up next. I said, are you serious? I try, but I can't figure out. I've been next to you all night. I still don't know what you're about. You keep talking. Jaybird recently had some blood work done, hoping that he's very healthy and that blood work has now come back and you have the results. What are the results, Jaybird? You look fit. You look amazing.
You look insane. But what are the results?
I tested positive for marinara sauce.
No, okay. I'm just not.
No, I... What?
What?
I was just trying to have a little fun. No, my numbers came back very good. In fact, she said my liver was great.
Good.
To the point where I kind of started...
How?
I started to almost...
Okay.
I kind of started to blush.
Let's go. This weekend, we need to put a little dent in it.
Tons of whiskey helps livers?
She said so much great things about my kidney. I was like, oh my gosh, do go on. I felt like I was turning red from just blushing. Cause,
really?
And then my kidney function was great.
Okay.
The one kidney that I have.
Okay.
Good.
Kidney
good.
And liver are both good.
Yes, they are good.
Okay. Did she say anything about the brain?
That I have to do a special test on.
Something entirely different. But
as far as your normal cholesterol, all that stuff was in the normal range.
No, pancake. I know you were fearing the pancake.
Just anytime I Google anything, even if it's for the sniffles, it always leads me to pancreatic cancer for some reason.
Yeah, can't Google.
But yeah, so far, yeah, so that was good.
Blood cells all look normal and awesome.
Everything looks good.
Yay!
So what you're doing right, Bird. Very
He's
nice.
Not dead by Easter.
Yes.
Well, that's still TBD.
You can still get hit by a bus.
Something could still
But you're not going to die from any kind of organ failure. All your organs look good. Look at you.
So the people are wishing diabetes on me. You're just going to have to wait a couple more years.
Not going to happen yet.
But he's working on it. He's definitely putting the work in with the pastry.
Unfortunately, right now, I'm in training for the Crawfish Festival. So
that's right.
I'm on a health run right now.
Yeah, Virginia, show me. You made the poster this year.
Oh, my gosh. And I'm not opening up for her 8-year-old son this year?
That I don't know.
We're really moving up in the world, a snack pack.
Mm-hmm. No, you're not opening up for School of Rock.
Yeah.
You're later in the day on Saturday.
Okay.
Look at that.
Look at you.
So this means you'll be able to try one of Virginia's delicious chocolates, I believe.
Bring on the chocolate.
Yeah, baby. So these were handmade by Rocco Sinicki. Now, they're not pretty. I'm showing them to you on KVJ TV. Uh-huh. They're peanut butter cups made by an 8-year-old, y'all. So keep your comments to yourself. But I think they're pretty tasty. And it was his first attempt at confectures.
Okay.
This is one healthy Jaybird eating some food.
Okay.
Ooh, you know what? I like the look.
Right?
It's got kind of a sandwich feel.
He decided he wanted to make them all double deckers. So it's like double peanut butter.
I don't think Bird's going to say no to that. Okay.
He's chewing.
What are you thinking about this 8-year-old's chocolates, Bird?
We're all watching him chew. It kind of feels creepy.
It's a lot of peanut butter.
So maybe a little heavy on the peanut butter,
no.
Or is that just okay? Is that a good thing or a bad thing?
Let it marinate. Let it dance on your tongue, baby.
I only said it's a lot of peanut butter because I couldn't talk.
He's like when you give the dog peanut butter and the dog's like nong, nong, nong.
That right there, heaven in a nutshell.
Wow. You like it.
It's delicious.
Rocco got the recipe from a cookbook that he checked out of his school library.
I love it.
Recipes for kids.
Oh, wow.
And so he's very proud. You want to try one, Kev?
I'll take a little bite of one.
Knock you right out of ketosis.
I mean, they're not that big.
It's kind of fits in. What do you call these little cups? It'd be like a...
So these are like mini little cupcake cups. Mm-hmm.
You should call
it looks like a little hamburger.
You should call them Rocco's Pizzies. Rocco's Pizzies. Rocco's? Okay, I'll stop saying it.
From the naming department?
Yeah.
Reese's Pieces.
I get it. Well, no, we got it.
No, I got it.
That's very good. I mean, that is right on with a Reese's Peanut Butter Cup. It's,
wow.
It is right there. I wouldn't, you know. Wouldn't know the difference. Look, it looks different, but it doesn't taste different. It's just as delicious.
Wow, Rocco, you hear that?
What an impressive. What do they call it? What's the technical term for a candy maker? Confection?
He's a confectioner.
Yeah.
Confectioner.
What was the last decade you had a Reese's cup?
Oh, man. I had little bites. Honestly, I think Rocco's is better because I would say, I think the last time that I did have a Reese's, there's something about the peanut butter. It got a little chemically for me. And that tastes a little bit more natural in the way that it should.
No chemicals. We made everything from scratch, and it's healthy stuff.
I'd say Rocco's is better.
Your opinion echoes many people's opinions when it comes to the snack world, Kevin. I'd say about 25% of that community.
Yeah, we've talked about that a little bit. Just even the difference between American chocolate and European chocolate. We put too many chemicals in it. It's not as good. And you can't taste the difference. That's like pure good chocolate.
We put stuff in our chocolate that is not allowed in European countries. Mm-hmm. We use chemicals in our chocolate to make it more profitable for these companies. Chemicals that are banned in Europe, we use here.
Yeah.
That tells you something. They've banned this stuff because it's like not good for you. It causes disease and cancer, and it's just, you got to read your labels. And America, get it right.
Okay. Rocco-lit. Chocolate, Rocco-lit chocolate. Come on.
Rocco-lit chocolate.
All right, we're warming up.
Okay.
We're warming up.
He would like that. I'm going to tell him to make a commercial on his illegal YouTube page for Rocco-lit chocolate.
They haven't shut that down yet?
They have not, because he figured a way around the system.
Oh, the workaround, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. Good
He's
for
no
him.
Dummy.
Good for him. Okay. All right. Well, coming up here in just a couple of minutes on the KVJ show, man. The scams, the stories that have been coming out the last couple of weeks about squatters. Most famously, there was this woman, she had her own property that she got from her parents when they passed, and squatters got in there, and she went to go kick them out, and she got arrested. Isn't that crazy?
It is.
Wow.
It is crazy.
Isn't that insane?
There's ways to beat squatters, though. I saw a guy and what he did to do it. It was pretty good. He beat them quickly.
Yeah, you can hire this guy. I saw him, too. He'll come do it for you.
Well, because he was a victim of a squatter, and he got his squatters out within a day or two.
That's impressive.
Because there are times where it can go on for 4 to 6 months, man.
Yeah. Yep.
Some people have really struggled with it. They've lost a ton of money because of it, and Florida recognized this, and they've got some new rules on the books. You may think this would never happen to you, but it could. So what do you have to do to get a squatter out of your place now in Florida? I'll break it down for you next.
From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
StormSmart provides homeowners with StormCatcher screens. The leading hurricane safety product on the market, StormSmart screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-60-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation. Watch out for an accident on 10th Avenue North at Dixie Highway causing delays. Plus, a major accident has shut down Florida's Turnpike North between Atlantic Boulevard and Dr. Martin Luther King Boulevard. Use Lyons Road, 441, or I-95 as your alternate route. From the 850 WFTL Traffic Center, I'm Evelyn Romo.
Hard Rock Bet presents Legal in Florida.
You can bet the game on Hard Rock Bet. No more betting inside your head.
A no-regret first bet up to $100 when you sign up now. Offered by the Seminole Tribe of Florida. Must be 21 and over and physically present in Florida to wager. Terms and conditions apply. Concerned about gambling? Please call 1-888-ADMITTED.
On an MSC cruise, beauty is everywhere. It's in the thrill of a water slide, top-notch entertainment, and in quieter propellers. It's in the sunset and that toast on your very first night on board. Discover the beauty of Ocean Key, MSC's private island marine reserve, and more destinations with up to 40% off cruises, plus drinks, Wi-Fi, and more included. MSC Cruises, for a greater beauty. To book, visit msccruises.com or contact your travel advisor. Restrictions apply. Ships registered in Panama, Malta.
Well, hello, Winn-Dixie, and hello to winning Easter deals. Right now, USDA Choice Beef Bone-In Rib Roast is $6.99 a pound. And get winning deals on essentials every bunny will love. Save on your Easter feast and earn points with Winn-Dixie Rewards. Winn-Dixie, it's a win-win. Limit one USDA Choice Beef Bone-In Rib Roast per rewards account with a $20 purchase. While supplies last, exclusions apply. See winn-dixie.com/offer-exclusions for details.
Hey, West Palm Beach, looking for new ways to save? Well, on Verizon, you don't need to be on a family plan to get our best deals. For a limited time, plans start at just $55 a month for a single line on Unlimited Welcome, with autopay plus taxes and fees. That's a savings of $10 a month. Plus, get a select phone on us and a $100 Verizon gift card when you switch. There's never been a better time to switch to the network America relies on. This offer won't last long. Visit your local Verizon store to switch and save big today. Minimum $599.99 up to $659.99 device payment or full retail purchase with new smartphone line on unlimited welcome plan required. $100 Verizon e-gift card sent within 8 weeks with port in. Less up to $659.99 promo credit applied over 36 months. 0% APR. $360 local promo credit applied over 36 months for new customers with one new line. Additional terms apply. In select markets only. Auto pay and paper-free billing required. For unlimited welcome plan in times of congestion, unlimited 5G and 4G LTE may be temporarily slower than other traffic. Domestic data roaming at 2G speeds.
Experience the Anajar and Levine difference. Call 1-800-747-FREE.
South Florida weather is 15 seconds away from the H. Gregg West Palm Beach Weather Center.
Score big savings this March at hgregg.com on Military Trail. Check out a slam dunk selection of pre-owned vehicles. They've got the lineup that will make you feel like a champion on the road. hgregg.com, where every drive is a victory lap. Save more, drive happy.
Mostly cloudy this morning. A few light showers or drizzles, too, as temperatures are in the mid-70s. That's a mild start. Even warmer and humid this afternoon with highs in the mid-80s. But a cold front passing through with very breezy conditions and also a few passing showers this afternoon. I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Jennifer Correa on 97.9 WRMF.
This report is sponsored by Valvoline Instant Oil Change.
Looking for a premium oil change? Drive into Valvoline Instant Oil Change. Stay in your car and be back on the road in about 15 minutes. Our expert technicians use premium products for top-notch vehicle care. Quick, easy, trusted. That's Valvoline Instant Oil Change.
What you need to know on the KVJ Show.
Do you listen to the KVJ Show through your smart speaker at home? If you've got one, you can. Just talk to your smart speaker and say, play the KVJ Show. And there we are, hopefully playing through your entire home. If you want to hear us when we're not on live, all you have to do is say play the KVJ Show podcast. Anytime, on demand, KVJ is always there on your smart speakers. It's a crazy concept. You own a home. Someone comes in and they take it over and you can't get into it.
It's insanity.
It really is insane. And we've talked about this for years. It has been a problem in Florida where you have a lot of transients, and then you have a lot of homes that do sit open. And, man, for decades we've had this story, and I was always so amazed at the nightmarish stories of people trying to get squatters out of their place. I'm like, what the heck, man? I don't understand. But, you know, people could put their name on a water bill, present some kind of almost forged papers, and then it became a to-do. And what do you know? Somebody would be living for months or years in a property they weren't paying rent on.
All they have to do is fake a lease, fake a rental agreement, and bring that and get one piece of mail in their name delivered there. And apparently that's all you need. Like, what the hell? Yeah. You got that piece of mail based on a forged lease.
Right.
So if what began the process was fake, at no part in the process you'd be allowed to stay there.
There's a mom and son combo. They were doing it for, I think, 12 years without ever really getting caught. They'd go from house to house, and they were living rent-free. And as soon as the heat would get too much, they'd go to a new house.
Wow. How about that? Well, I think those days maybe coming to an end on July 1st. Governor Ron DeSantis, he just signed a bill that allows a property owner to request the county sheriff's office to remove a squatter immediately after showing proof of ownership.
Calling it criminal instead of civil.
Yeah.
That makes a big difference, because if something is civil, then you got to go through the court, and it takes time. But if it's criminal, then the cops can show up and they can take care of business and be the cops that they were trained to be and kick them out.
It's kind of insane that it's never been criminal.
Right?
Yeah.
It should be the most criminal. You forged documents and went to the sewer and water place and got the water bill in your name.
So under the law, a property owner can request law enforcement immediately remove a squatter if the person has unlawfully entered, has refused to leave after being told by the homeowner to do so and is not a current or former tenant in a legal dispute. So people who may have a bad landlord can't just be thrown out by these issues. If you're taking it to court and contesting it, you still have to go through that process. And that does feel right, because you do have to have some rights for people that are in a place and have a bad landlord.
Totally.
But now people who present a false lease or deed that you were just talking about, Virginia, are committing a first degree felony.
Yay.
People who list homes for sale or rent without having the legal authority to do so, that is a first-degree felony punishable by up to 30 years in prison.
Good. That's important, too, because people are listing homes and apartments for, for rent, and they're showing the places they don't own. They're collecting deposits.
Yeah.
They're scamming people out of thousands and thousands, like first, last, and security.
Yep.
That's a lot of money.
It was insane. It was just mad. Madness. And now somebody who unlawfully occupies a home and who causes more than $1,000 in damage commits a second degree felony punishable by up to 15 years in prison. So that's now what we're looking at for squatters. You do what you used to be able to do and get away with it scot-free in Florida. Now you are doing 15 to 30 years in prison.
That is a good thing.
Dang, huh? That's crazy. They did say if you do have a property that you're not in, just to kind of help you with the legalities of it, it is important to post a no trespassing sign and have a documented photo of the date that you posted the sign. That will expedite things with the sheriff or in a court.
Okay.
And they say cameras, too, also help document things. So if you do have a rental property or a place like that one woman I was just talking about, that she had inherited a home from her parents, she wasn't occupying, squatters got in it, she goes to kick them out, she gets arrested. You know, if she would have had the no trespassing sign with the documented photo and cameras, then it wouldn't have been an issue. And in fact, in Florida now, that was in another state.
Right.
And that's why they say Florida could be leading the nation with this new law taking effect on July 1st, where other states would be like, you know what? That's a good idea. We got to do that, man.
It should.
Yeah, it really should. It's just common sense, right?
Because when I used to live over in Riviera Beach, right there by the water, I mean, there were some beautiful houses, and then there were some houses that needed to be fixed up. Mm-hmm. There was a house, like, seriously, three houses in from the water that needed to be fixed up. Mm-hmm. These squatters moved in it and destroyed it.
Wow.
And the guy that owned it couldn't get them out. Mm-hmm. It was a whole thing. You would see them fighting all the time in the yard. It was so dramatic.
Dang.
And these squatters caused thousands of dollars in damage.
They now do 15 years in prison for that.
There's some great squatter videos out there on YouTube. There's one where the news goes and the guy gets all mad, the one that's squatting, and he picks a big old pipe out of his truck and runs after the news camera.
Dang.
It's all caught.
Oh, wow.
They run it on the news and then the guy gets arrested.
Dang.
It's so good.
There's a crazy story I just saw in North Korea. The blue jeans that a TV host was wearing on a British gardening show was blurred out because jeans in North Korea is a symbol of U.S. imperialism. So this guy's walking around this garden with a blurred, and you think he's maybe naked or something, gardening naked?
He's Porky Pig-ing.
You're like, what is this gardener doing? Because he's all blurred out. No, it's just to blur out the jeans.
I like naked gardening.
You cannot wear jeans in North Korea. They're banned. You would be arrested if you wore blue jeans in North Korea.
And that's because it's such a symbol of America.
Yeah, imperialism, yeah. They hate it that much. But I got to tell you, you want to talk about loving the USA? Man, I got some North Korea fact or fiction for you of some of the crazy things and the laws their citizens have to abide by coming up next.
Just a young gun with a quick fuse. I was uptight, wanna let loose. I was dreaming of bigger things and wanna leave my old life behind. Not a yes sir, not a follower. Fit the box, fit the mold, have a seat in the foyer. Take a number. I was lightning before the thunder.
Thunder, 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 thunder,
thunder, thunder, thunder, thunder, thunder,
thunder,
thunder, feel the thunder. Lightning and the thunder. Thunder, feel the thunder. Lightning and the thunder. Thunder, thunder, thunder.
Laugh.
this while I was scheming for the masses. Who do you think you are? Dreaming about being a big star. They say you're basic, they say you're easy. You're always riding in the backseat. Now I'm smiling from the stage while you were clapping.
Crazy video watching this gardener on a British show with his bottom blurred out, all because he was wearing blue jeans. And in North Korea, they don't allow blue jeans at all because it is a symbol of U.S. imperialism. So they're banned in the country, and they're even banned on all media. You can't even show them, so they blur them out.
I thought at some point Americans could go over there and visit if they wanted to. I don't think they can anymore unless they've got a special, you know, code or badge or something.
Yeah, I think it's kind of closed down a little bit.
Well, I remember that one auto guy that ended up going over there and he ended up getting... It was a bad story.
Yes, he was ripping down posters,
yes,
and they beat the living you know what out of him,
and then he passed away.
He came back in a vegetative state and then passed away.
They don't play.
They don't play.
I think since that, I think it's hard for anyone to go over there.
Yeah.
Why would you want to go?
Exactly.
There's plenty of places to play tourists.
Yeah. I mean, other than Dennis Rodman, no American is safe there.
I think he gets clearance.
And he can step out of line and be in a vegetative state at any minute, too.
If you get any free time, just YouTube Dennis Rodman press conference North Korea basketball. It's something else.
Okay.
Good to know.
Something else. Okay, so the whole country is something else. There's some insane things happening there, not just banning blue jeans. Got to tell me, is this fact or fiction about real things going on in North Korea? Virginia. Is this fact or fiction? Your haircut must be government approved. Can you imagine that? Fact or fiction? What do you think on that?
I mean, they love to control everything, but your hair?
Mm-hmm. Your hair? Fact or fiction?
I'm going to say fact.
Going to say fact on that, yes.
Wow, I couldn't have long hair.
No.
Well, what it is, they have 15 different government-approved options.
Wow.
And you have to have one of those 15 hairstyles or you will be arrested.
We're giving you the flat top cop.
Please tell me there's the North Korean version of the mullet.
Don't know. I don't know. I don't know what those 15 styles are, but yes, you must comply.
I have to check
out. Kevin, is there a bowl cut?
I got to check out these 15 styles. They have to be available online.
Okay, yeah. That could be our punishment for the next Do It Bitch. You have to get a North Korean haircut. Okay, what about this, Jay Bird? You're required to join the military at age 16 in North Korea. Fact or fiction?
Fact.
That is a fiction. It's a little tricky because you don't enlist till you're 17. Oh. Breathe easy at 16, 17, you're going in, baby. That's
no
how
matter
they do
what.
It. Yep, no matter what. Every North Korean is doing that.
Horrifying.
Fact or fiction, Virginia. All teachers in the 90s in North Korea were required to play accordions.
Please be real.
Is that fact or fiction?
Accordions?
Accordions.
There's no way.
Accordions. All teachers, to have a job teaching in North Korea, you had to play the accordion.
I kind of want it to be fact, Jay Bird.
Oh, I mean,
you're saying no way?
That's so goofy. That's
all right.
So over the
you
top.
Talked me into it. We're a team today. We're saying fiction.
You're saying fiction?
Damn it, Bird.
Oh, my gosh.
I should have listened to my gut.
It's a fact. It was a fact, because in North Korea, the accordion is called the people's instrument. So to properly teach the youth, you had to be able to play the accordion and teach them the people's instrument.
I do love the accordion.
I don't know. Is it really the people's instrument? Do the people say that? I doubt that.
There's one guy that says everything the people say.
Yeah.
He's in charge of your opinion.
So where and when did it? When did the officials finally go, all right, I don't think this accordion rules
working.
It
ended in the 90s.
Why, though? There's got to be a reason why.
Yeah, I didn't do that deep of a dive on North Carolina.
No, I'm just
North Carolina.
I'm just curious.
Yeah. Okay, what about this? Fact or fiction, farting in public in North Korea is illegal. Is that fact or fiction? What do you think, Jay Bird?
It's a fact.
You're going to say that is a fact? No, that's fiction.
Oh, dang. We're not doing so good.
No. Well, I don't know if you want to do well on this, honestly. Okay, Virginia, what do you think? North Korea, fact or fiction? Former North Korean dictator Kim Jong-il claimed that he had never farted. Is that fact or fiction?
I think that's a fact.
That is a fact. Yeah.
He was delusional. His baby is delusional. They're all delusional.
It wasn't him. If you went around and talked to people in North Korea, they believed that Kim Jong-il had never farted and had never pooped either because he was that pure.
Do they really believe that, or are they scared to believe that?
And I believe the opposite. More pooping makes you more pure. You got the stuff out of you, baby.
Well, he just wouldn't even build up the toxins to have to get rid of.
I would just love to hear someone be honest when you're at your house. Would you and your family go, I mean, isn't this crazy? We have to see this guy doesn't fart? Are you serious?
The guy's holding a cane he's going to beat me with. I'll say whatever you want.
Yeah.
What about this, Jay Bird? Fact or fiction? North Korean dictator Kim Jong-il claimed that he got 4 hole-in-ones the first time he ever played golf.
That's a fact.
That is fiction.
Oh.
He said he got 11 holes in one, and he shot 38 under par the first time he ever played golf.
That's amazing.
So he's a prodigy.
I mean, 11 holes in one.
It's pretty awesome.
All right, last one for you, Virginia. North Korea, fact or fiction? Smoking weed is legal in North Korea. Is that fact or fiction?
Smoking weed.
Yeah. Of all these crazy laws, you can actually smoke weed there.
I'm going to say fiction.
You are right.
I was going to say, no way.
If he won't even let you rock a mullet, he's not going to let you toke up.
But the odd thing, they say even though it's illegal, it's unlikely to be punished severely. Apparently, they grow a lot of marijuana in North Korea.
All right, so it's just like the U.S.
Uh-huh, yeah. And finally, Jaber, what do you think? It's illegal to own a Bible in North Korea, fact or fiction?
That's a fact.
That is a fact, yes. Ownership of religious materials brought in from abroad is illegal and punishable by imprisonment and other forms of severe punishment, including execution. They kill you. How about that, huh?
That is insane.
I mean, from your fact and fiction, you make it sound like there's no way you could be happy in North Korea. And if you aren't happy, you better act like you are.
Yeah, I just kind of wonder that. I didn't even scratch the surface on how repressive that government is for their people. USA.
Say what?
USA.
We are so lucky.
I know, right?
Here's what's coming up on the Dirt of the Day. Dirt of the Day.
Well, coming up in your Dirt of the Day, federal officials have issued a statement about the whole Diddy thing. What are they doing and what are they saying? I'll share it with you coming up in your Dirt.
Entertainment updates 5 minutes after every hour from the KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF.
From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
StormSmart provides homeowners with StormCatcher screens, the leading hurricane safety product on the market. StormSmart screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-60-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation. Watch out for an accident on 10th Avenue North at Dixie Highway causing delays. Plus, a major accident has shut down Florida's Turnpike North between Atlantic Boulevard and Dr. Martin Luther King Boulevard. Use Lyons Road, 441, or I-95 as your alternate route. From the 850 WFTL Traffic Center, I'm Evelyn Romo.
Rosalitas! Rosalitas!
Spice up your life with the best, most authentic Tex-Mex grill in Palm Beach at Rosalitas in Lantana. They welcome you to the award-winning restaurant with only the finest meats, poultry, and fish dishes. A family-run restaurant since 1994. The minute you walk in the door of Rosalitas, you'll smell the aroma of delicious fajitas, burritos, or enchiladas made fresh to order. Their friendly staff is always ready to serve you with your favorite Tex-Mex dish, such as carne asada, fish tacos, baby back ribs, or Santa Fe salad, spinach, and chicken enchiladas. Or you can always go the lighter side with a tortilla soup and a taco salad. Rosalitas is open daily, starting with happy hour from 11 till 7, lunch and dinner. And there's always something fun going on at Rosalitas with karaoke on Tuesdays and Fridays and live music on Saturdays. What are you waiting for? Come and spice up your life. 561-964-5747 on the corner of Lantana and Congress.
Come and spice up your life at Rosalitas. Rosalitas.
The Jeep Celebration event is going on right now with exceptional offers on a wide selection of Jeep brand vehicles. If you're looking to supercharge your next adventure, look no further than America's best-selling plug-in hybrid, the Jeep Wrangler 4xe. Or choose the luxurious Grand Cherokee or Grand Cherokee 4xe. All celebrations must come to an end, so hurry and visit Jeep.com or your local Jeep brand dealer for great deals during the Jeep Celebration event. Based on 2022 CYQ4 sales, J.D. Power retail sales data. Jeep is a registered trademark.
Coconut shrimp is back at Pollo Tropical. We're serving a perfectly golden, sweet, and savory coconut shrimp in a bowl, platter, or as a side with our pineapple rum sauce. Don't miss out on coconut shrimp at Pollo Tropical. Try it today.
Joint pain. It's something that can literally stop us in our tracks. At QC Kinetics, we offer a revolutionary specialized course of treatment perfected over 10 years that can eliminate your pain. Our regenerative therapies actually repair damaged tissue, restoring the joint and eliminating the pain, not masking it with drugs or risky invasive surgery. If you suffer with joint pain, arthritis, age, degeneration, or a sports injury, and have been told you need knee, hip, shoulder, or back surgery, QC Kinetics offers revolutionary non-surgical solutions with actual regrowth of your own tissue with no downtime and long-lasting results. Call right now and set up your free examination with one of our highly specialized doctors at one of our 6 leading-edge clinics in Palm Beach, Broward, and Miami. Experience VIP medical care at its best. Call right now and see how you can get your first treatment free. Call 800-292-3979. That's 800-292-3979. 800-292-3979.
Injured? Visit Lytle Rider Smith, Ivy, and Fromrath at FourYearRights.com.
From the Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach Studio.
We want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
This is 97.9 WRMF Palm Beach.
It's the KVJ.
Dirt of the day.
It's the KVJ.
Dirt of the day.
Virginia, take it away.
Because you know we need that dirt of the day.
Well, we now have an official statement from the feds. Now, the feds are the ones that raided 2 of Diddy's homes on Monday. They say that they've been interviewing alleged victims. And basically what the victims were telling them is everything. And they believe there is a disturbing history of sex trafficking based on explicit, detailed, concrete allegations. They said, look, it's not random. We didn't choose Diddy's name out of a hat. We have allegations from many people that we are following up on. And we believed from that information that we got from the alleged victims that there would be photos, emails, texts, itineraries, names, and a bunch of information on his electronic devices had they not been wiped clean.
Uh-huh.
So that's what they were looking for. They were going looking for specific things to back up all of these allegations. They said, so far, Diddy is not under arrest. He is only under investigation. He's free to move about however he wants. He can go fly wherever he wants for now. But if charges do come down, they said they will find him wherever he is and arrest him.
Wow. Okay.
So there you go. I know a lot of people were putting out that fake mugshot of Diddy yesterday. I saw that all over the internet, and I was like, wait, they arrested him? What happened? And then I go looking for that, and it's not real. So as of now, he is under investigation, not arrest.
That picture tricked me during commercial break.
That damn internet, man.
It looked official, man.
It looked so official.
It looked like he was in cuffs, then they have a mugshot next to him.
Y'all got to stop with tricking people on the internet.
There's a lot of it out there, and the Diddy content is so popular right now that people are putting stuff out. So you do have to pause and take a second. But there are people that are credible voices that are speaking, and if they ever do, these are the people you got to worry about. I don't know if you remember the TV show Extra.
Yes.
Yes.
It was tabloid.
I love
celebrity.
Extra. It's so juicy and salacious.
One of their hosts was named Tanika Ray. Used to be on there about the time that Diddy was big.
I remember her.
And she's just another example of the people talking about, oh, yeah, I've got stuff. I have got stuff. Here's what she had to say about her Diddy stories.
You know, we all have stories. Seriously, we all have stories. Mine is horrific, and only 5 people know it. And I probably will never tell it. I got a lot of stories. Unfortunately, maybe I'll write a book one day, but it just is so traumatizing that women just want to live every day and feel safe. And when we revisit and revisit, we live in a state of victimhood, and nobody wants to live there. So for those who are like, why didn't you say something then? Because we just want to live. We want to be happy. And we really want to forget the trauma. So...
Okay, that's what she has to say. So would she speak up if things really started to fall on Diddy's head?
That is something I see a lot where people say, oh, you should have spoke up right then and there. And just knowing things in my own personal life where people have been affected by stuff like that, not everyone will say something because they are afraid to bring it up. It is embarrassing. So there is a lot of, you should have said something first. And believe me, I think there's a lot of it in Hollywood where people are saying too much to get some shine, to get the likes and the shares. Mm. But with that said, the reality is there are a lot of people who get put in a situation that's horrible, it's uncomfortable, and they don't want to talk about it because it is very traumatizing. That is a real thing.
They're also afraid of Diddy. I mean, yeah, everybody's looking at Diddy right now, but y'all, Diddy is still powerful and maybe could hurt you. That's got to be a fear.
Well, there's a lot of contextual clues that are coming up. Even the clip that they had when Kanye went off in concert a couple years ago, and he was talking to Jay-Z and don't bring the killers after me. And they're making some connections. There's a lot of stuff trying to now start connecting Jay-Z into all this. And that he had almost an equal part, but he was just smarter than Diddy. And he did a good job of doing his dirty work and keeping it hidden, whereas now Diddy's stuff, because he wasn't smart enough, is now all starting to come out.
Well, even if nothing comes out at that level, at minimum, people are coming out saying Jay-Z was the gatekeeper of people's career. And if you rub him the wrong way, you are done. You weren't getting in anywhere. And he had the power to hold your career back, even if it wasn't deserving.
Yeah. And there's a lot of mysterious deaths that have happened in the industry that, you know, that we touched on a few of those yesterday.
Deaths around Diddy that you can show that he profited from. That to me is like, whoa.
Yeah.
But if you get Diddy, you're going to start getting a lot more people. People are going to start rolling over on each other.
Good.
They are. It's coming.
We don't keep dirtbag secrets. Mm-hmm. And if you have secrets on a dirtbag, tell them.
Yeah.
They deserve to be punished.
Well, we got a lot more coming up in the next Dirt at 8, I want to go a little bit down the path that you were, Jaybird, about Jennifer Lopez smuggling that gun into the club where somebody wound up shot with that gun. And the illusion is that possibly J-Lo lied under oath. She could be in some serious trouble. They could reopen this grand jury testimony. And Diddy was actually the person that pulled the trigger. The woman who says she was shot in the face is the one who's talking. Whoa. It was supposedly somebody else. And she said, nope, I was the one that was shot. I saw the whole thing. I saw the Jennifer Lopez part. She lied. So if they put her on the stand, you know, there are other people like Jay-Z, Jennifer Lopez, who are in the Diddy universe in that time that could be nervous. So we'll get a little bit more into it coming up at 8, too.
Jenny from the block, Jenny with a Glock.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
How long you been thinking about that one?
Just as good. Kevin was
That's
saying.
Good. That's good. That's good. That's good.
Yeah.
Well, Jay Bird, you might have missed your boat. I know you got a thing for Shakira, but apparently she has found a new lover.
Rats.
Too bad you didn't go to this surprise concert she played Tuesday night in Times Square. Just, I'm here. It's Shakira. How cool would that be? You just walk up on Times Square and it's a free Shakira concert. But apparently she and one of these hotties, one of these actors from the show Emily in Paris, Lucian is his name.
Oh, wow.
Sexy Latin name.
Has to be hot.
Has to be hot. Apparently they were eating at Carbone, which is like such an expensive, exclusive Italian restaurant.
Well, if you want to be seen and you want to have a story written about you, that's the restaurant you go to.
Yes. There's one in Miami, Jay Bird, but I'm sure you know that.
Of course. Carbone.
Bring the girl you want to bone to Carbone. It's impressive. Shakira and Lucian, her new man, out on the town. And finally here, Beyonce has seemingly released the track list to her new album, Cowboy Carter. And guess what one of the titles on the album is? Jolene. Oh, is she doing a remake of it?
Probably.
Yes, is it a duet?
That would make the 7,000th remake of Jolene.
I like it. I'm here for it.
It's a wildly covered song.
But it's a good song. And that's what's going on in your dirt.
Gotta wish a happy birthday to Lady Gaga today. 38 years old. Birthday, Gaga. Julia Stiles, she was in the Bourne movies. She is now 43 years old. And Vince Vaughn from Old School Wedding Crashers. He is turning 54 years old today.
He has got he does a run on Curb Your Enthusiasm the last three seasons.
Oh, really? Okay. Yeah. Is he good on it?
Yeah, he's pretty good.
Pretty good. Okay. Also, Sophia, happy sweet 16 from the Duvas. Also, Debbie Hernandez, happy 45th birthday. Greatest mom, wife, friend, and animal lover. That is from Jorge, Mel, and David and the Fur Babies. Also, a little shout out to my beautiful daughter, Pearl, who turns 11.
I love that name, Pearl.
That's from Mommy the Pups, B, Sadie and Uncle Marcus, Aunt Casey and Aunt Valerie. Happy 42nd to my amazing son, Chris, pushing 10 in the ATL. Look forward to having cocktails again soon. Love, Mama Wood. And there is their photo. Aww. Very nice.
So he's not turning 10.
Maybe he's a leap year baby.
No, he's 42.
Okay. Maybe they're,
did I say 10?
Maybe their 10-year anniversary.
10.
Oh,
T-I-N. T-I-N. Not gotcha. 10. Yeah, he's pushing 10.
Oh, maybe he's an air traffic controller.
Not sure.
You're kind of ruining Kevin's birthdays.
Whatever. You ruined Kevin's life.
What?
Jeez, wow.
That's a little harsh, Kevin. Please tell her that's not true.
He makes my life complete. What are you talking about?
Whatever. I make the birthdays, bitch.
Okay, happy birthday to Barry, loyal listener in Maine from Palm Beach. That is wife Davia, all the kids, Elka, and our dog as well. Thank you for the birthdays. You got one, you want to get a shout out, you can let us know. Hit us up, mail@kvjshow.com. Coming up here in a second, I'll let you know what happened with that Powerball drawing and the sad reality that is hitting that Mega Millions winner.
Sad?
Yeah.
How can they be sad? They won the Mega Millions.
I'm going to give you the reality of it, Virginia. It is kind of sad, actually. Aww. I won over $1 billion and I got bad news for you. Yeah, kind of. So I got this question as well. Would you rather have a 100% chance of winning $1 million or a 75% chance of winning $100 billion? You can walk away with nothing.
Oh my God, this is too much math. I'm out.
I like this, Ross. This is a good one.
Okay. All right. I'll give you 3 minutes to figure it out, Virginia.
I can't.
I'll see if you can do it in that time.
I can't.
I only talk to God when I need a favor. And I only pray when I ain't got a prayer. So who the hell am I? Who the hell am I to expect a savior? Oh, if I only talk to God when I need a favor, God, I need a favor. I know amazing grace, but I ain't been living them words. Swear I spend more Sundays drunk off my ass than I have in church. Hardcover King James, only been saving dust on the nightstand. And I don't know what to say. Like Hail Marys, if you're still there, Lord, spare me. Oh my God, Hail Mary. Hanging in there, just barely throwing up prayers. Like Hail Marys, if you're still there, Lord, spare me. Oh my God, Hail Mary. I only talk to God when I need a favor. And I
know if it's bad news per se, but it could be a little disappointing. Imagine you have just won the Mega Millions lottery that was just won by a person in New Jersey just this week.
One ticket,
and you're saying to yourself, I won one of the five biggest Mega Millions drawings of all time. My take-in is pretty impressive. $1.13 billion. Man, I am a billionaire. But you say, you know, financially, the right thing to do is to take the lump sum. So I'm not a billionaire anymore. I got $540 million.
Aww.
But then you have somebody come up to you and you say, hey, you know you got to pay taxes on that. You're like, yeah, okay, well, how much do I get? That person who won $1.13 billion now has $280 million. Still awesome, But when you're building it up in your head, you're going, I have $1.13 billion. Now I got $280 million. It went that fast. What the heck, man?
That is crazy how much it goes.
That like is.
That. I mean, that's really what you want. I mean, they build it up of like, oh, no, $1.13 billion. No, it's actually realistically they're going to get $280 million. That's what it is. They're never going to put that on the highway billboard sign that you see. They don't figure in the taxes to all that kind of stuff. Isn't that the way?
Taxes really are a bummer.
Yeah.
They are. Whether you got $1 million or $10, taxes suck.
They're the fun police just waiting to ruin
all
your
fun. The fun suckers.
Man, gosh. Yeah. Well, the good news is you still got a pretty sizable Powerball jackpot. Nobody won it last night.
Yeah, your numbers didn't come up, Jay Byrne.
No,
I'm slipping.
Why don't you try to... What do you see dancing over Kevin for next drawing on Powerball? Because this one's rolling over, baby.
I'm blocked right now. It's like I'm mentally constipated.
Mm. Okay.
I can't see anything right now.
Well, poop it out. Come on.
The numbers last night, 37, 46, 57, 60, and 66. The Powerball was 8. So since we had no winner last night, matching all 6 numbers, the drawing coming up on Saturday is going to be $935 million. That lump sum payout is going to be $449.7 million. You will receive $400,000 after taxes.
Okay.
No, just kidding. It's better than that. Virginia with her math skills was like, okay.
All right, I'll take it.
Yeah.
Hey, it's way
Virginia
more than I got now.
Wins the Powerball, go right to her and offer to be your tax attorney. Virginia, after taxes, you got $300. Oh, cool.
Thank you.
All right, thanks. I'm so blessed. Thank you. Okay, so I gave you 3 minutes to do this math for this Would You Rather.
Oh, boy.
Would you rather have a 100% chance of winning $1 million or just a 75% chance of winning $100 billion? 25% chance you walk away with nothing. What do you choose? Jay Bird?
I'm going for the big dog. Going full gorilla, 75%.
Absolutely.
Yes.
I say you go big dog. You go big or go home, man. I mean, because you walk away with nothing, but you got nothing now.
That's major odds in your favor.
$100 billion, and then after taxes, you'll get like $100 million.
You're right.
No, I'm taking the other one.
You're taking the definite 100% chance at winning $1 million.
Bird in the hand is worth two in the bush.
Okay, here's your $250,000 check.
I've got Denny's put up a poll. Would you rather have a 100% chance of winning $1 million or a 75% chance of winning $100 billion?
We should make it for the sake of the game and fun. We should say no taxes are being taken out.
Yeah, in fantasy land.
It's either the reality of it. I mean, you
it's
know.
1 million.
But you're going to have taxes of both.
Okay, we're throwing reality into our fantasy game. My bad.
Yeah, that's it. It's got to be a dash of reality in it, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, so what about this? Would you rather date someone with their ex's name tattooed on their chest or date someone whose ex lives next door?
Ex's name tattooed.
Yep, on the chest.
Definitely, definitely. Give me the tattoo all day.
What do you think, Bird?
Next door.
You're going to go with the ex who lives next door?
Yeah, because you can be broken up with somebody and never talk to them again, and then they live next door. It's happened to me.
Okay.
So, yeah, you can ignore somebody.
You don't want to see that
tattoo. No, a tattoo on the chest of the ex?
Every time we make love, he's Porky Pig in it.
Nah. Nah.
Okay. All right, would you rather date someone who doesn't like to watch what you do or listen to what kind of music you do? What do you want to have them match up with more, what you watch or what you listen to? What do you think is more important in a relationship?
What you watch.
What you watch, okay.
I watch more. If I'm dating somebody, we watch more stuff together than listen to music. Listening to music sometimes kind of a private thing for a lot of people.
Can be more individual. Okay, I got that. And how about this one? Would you rather let your significant other control your daily calendar or let them control your finances?
Oh my gosh. Option C, do not get married. Both of those are rough.
What do you think? Somebody gets to control your daily calendar or your finances? What would you rather have happen? They are rough.
I guess I got to go calendar because ain't nobody telling me how to do any money stuff except me.
Okay. So they're choosing what you do every day.
I guess so.
Okay. What do you think, Bird?
I can't have that. I can't have someone tell me.
Well, you have to pick one. It's Kevin's game.
No, can I finish? Good gosh. I forgot my answer. I'm going to say I can't have somebody pick my calendar.
Okay.
I can't.
Yeah, that'd be tough to be told where to go every day. I'm cool with being poor. I can live that way. I can make it happen. All right, so if you want to jump into our Would You Rather poll, have a 100% chance of winning $1 million or a 75% chance of winning $100 billion, all you have to do is go to YouTube and pull up the KVJ show and let us know. Right now, 77% of people are choosing the guaranteed $1 million. Only 33% are taking the chance of going for the $100 billion. Chicken.
Yeah, I am. I'm chicken.
Chicken.
I believe in a sure thing.
And you leave for Category 1 hurricanes. Chicken.
All right, coming up here in a couple of minutes, we got a quick round of some headphone karaoke, head-to-head battle, where you strap on headphones, you can't hear your own voice, and we get to judge your a cappella singing. Today, we got a head-to-head battle with Virginia and Jaybird.
All right.
Okay.
Bring it on, sweet cheeks.
All right, we'll see.
Scared.
Yeah, who is going to sing worse and do the You Suck shot? We'll find out next.
From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
StormSmart provides homeowners with storm catcher screens. The leading hurricane safety product on the market, StormSmart screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-60-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation.
Watch out for an accident on 10th Avenue North at Dixie Highway causing delays. Plus, a major accident has shut down Florida's Turnpike North between Atlantic Boulevard and Dr. Martin Luther King Boulevard. Use Lyons Road, 441, or I-95 as your alternate route. From the 850 WFTL Traffic Center, I'm Evelyn Romo.
If you're unaware, T-Mobile calls themselves the Un-Carrier, which is fitting considering they just unraveled their price lock guarantee for new customers. If you ask me, that's pretty uncool. If you're uncomfortable with a company that says one thing but does another, then switch to Xfinity, whose whole home Wi-Fi, wired internet, service, speed, and reliability are unparalleled. Unjoin the Un-Carrier. Switch to Xfinity today. Now through April 21st, new customers can get 300 megabits per second Xfinity Internet for $35. And ask how you can save 40% over T-Mobile in your first year. Switch today. Go to Xfinity.com/TMOFAX, call 1-800-XFINITY, or visit a store today. Requires paperless billing and auto pay with stored bank account and a one-year contract. Connect more Internet versus T-Mobile home Internet. $60 a month. Regular pricing applies after promo period. Restrictions apply. Taxes and fees extra. Actual speeds vary. Effective for new customers after 1/17/2024. T-Mobile's price lock will only reimburse your last bill if you terminate service due to a price increase.
I love the team at Dr. Rosenthal's. They are amazing. We were together this past weekend. Love, love them. They are celebrating 20 years of doing beautiful facial plastic surgery in Palm Beach County. Now, if you're thinking about anything face, this is what I always say. Go with an amazing, experienced, gentle, awesome surgeon like Dr. Rosenthal, because your face is not the place where you want to bargain shop. You want your face to be as close to natural perfection as possible. You need the skilled craftsmanship of somebody like Dr. Rosenthal, who's been doing it for 20 years. Experience matters. Fantastic bedside manner matters. I've watched him work. He let me be in the room for that beautiful lift that my girlfriend got, and it was amazing. Amazing to watch a facelift be done. It was so cool. If you want this for yourself, go with the best. Rosenthal-MD.com.
As a radio stuntman, I do all the extreme stuff in your favorite commercials. But the new Times the Cash scratch-offs are a new level of action-packed. A thrilling multiplier feature, over 15 million prizes that multiply the winnings, and bonus play. They're the most extreme! Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to jump this pit of hungry gates for no reason. New Times the Cash scratch-offs from the Florida Lottery. Must be 18 or older to play. Play responsibly.
Hi, it's Randy. I see you scrambling, trying to figure out what you're going to do for Easter. Well, Easter's this Sunday, March 31st.
There's no need to stress. We got you covered. The Honey Baked Ham Company has your solution.
With complete Easter meals. I'm talking about Honey Baked's complete Easter meals that are easy and convenient, so you spend less time in the kitchen.
Complete meals, including a bone-in or boneless ham, smoked or roasted turkey breast, and side dishes that are incredible.
There's still time, okay? Don't panic. Visit Honey Baked to place an order for pickup. Swing by your nearest Honey Baked Ham location. No reservation or pre-order is needed. That's how easy they make it for you. They've even extended store hours so you have more time to pick up. Honey Baked Ham this Easter, March 31st. They got you covered. Whether it's Easter brunch or dinner, they've got offerings for you.
Visit honeybaked.com to find a store near you.
Place that order for pickup. Find a store near you and look for those extended hours. Walk-in customers welcome too. Happy Easter from Honey Baked Ham.
Hey, is your credit on life support? Take a deep breath. Listen up. Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach hosting a credit clinic at the dealership today and tomorrow. Yeah, it's Nick Rivers. Local bank representatives, they're going to be on site to grant special approval to consumers who meet certain minimum criteria. If you got a job bringing home $350 a week, the credit clinic at Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach, they want to approve you so you can drive home in your new Kia today. Yeah, Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach hosting a credit clinic at the dealership today and tomorrow. If you have a job bringing home $350 a week, the credit clinic wants to approve you for a new Kia. What are you waiting for? Don't miss the credit clinic today and tomorrow at Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach. Call 800-NEW-KIAS online, greenwaykiawestpalmbeach.com, and remember,
we want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
Credit affects down payment and approval terms.
It is, without a doubt, my favorite meal of the whole entire week. It is brunch. And at Berry Fresh Cafe, they do breakfast, brunch, and lunch better than anybody, because that's all they do. Berry Fresh Cafe, now with four locations in Stewart, in Jupiter, in Port St. Lucie, and the new one, my favorite, in Palm Beach Gardens at US 1 and PGA. There's outside dining, which is doggy friendly, and then there's inside dining, which is so cute. Family owned and operated. Berry Fresh Cafe is a scratch kitchen. I love that. They seasonally rotate their menu, getting you the freshest ingredients. I love that. And they're farm to table, locally sourced, locally grown vegetables and produce and all kinds of proteins. I love that they care about using local ingredients. And, you know, I also care about the bar, full liquor, beer, wine. I love the mimosa flights, the Bloody Mary flights, the bacon-infused vodka. They're doing it right. Go check it out for a delicious breakfast, brunch, or lunch. It's Berry Fresh Cafe in Stewart, Jupiter, Port St. Lucie, and Palm Beach Gardens.
South Florida weather is 15 seconds away from the H. Gregg West Palm Beach Weather Center.
Score big savings this March at hgregg.com on Military Trail. Check out a slam dunk selection of pre-owned vehicles. They've got the lineup that will make you feel like a champion on the road. hgregg.com, where every drive is a victory lap. Save more, drive happy.
Mostly cloudy this morning. A few light showers or drizzles, too, as temperatures are in the mid-70s. That's a mild start. Even warmer and humid this afternoon with highs in the mid-80s. But a cold front passing through with very breezy conditions and also a few passing showers this afternoon. I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Jennifer Correa on 97.9 WRMF.
This report is sponsored by Allstate. Some people just know the best rate for you is a rate based on you with Allstate, not one based on anyone else. So if you drive safely, you could save money. Good to know. Visit Allstate.com or call for a quote today.
Time for a Dunkin' Run, the official coffee of 97.9 WRMF. What you need to know on the KVJ show.
Jaber, tell me about your Weird and Whatever podcast going down live tonight at 6 p.m. on the KVJ show YouTube channel.
Yeah, we're going to be talking about that one little girl who is being bullied at school by a ghost.
A ghost?
Yes.
Dun, 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 dun.
Of course, we're going to have our segment Ask Vicky, where we delve into the paranormal in the mind of our psychic medium Vicky.
Okay.
And then just a bunch of other fun stuff we're going to be talking about.
Good stuff.
Yeah.
If you want to catch other episodes, this is number four, I believe, of the season?
It is number four.
Got three other ones you can go and check out to get all ready for the Weird and Whatever tonight. They're already on the KBJ Show YouTube channel, and you can, of course, watch us right now live. We're on there. Just go to YouTube, look for the KBJ Show. Go to kbjshow.tv and make sure that you go on ahead and click like if you're watching right now and subscribe. Definitely would appreciate it. All right, time for another round of headphone karaoke. Our two challengers are going to be putting headphones on, and the song they're singing is going to be blaring into their ears. They won't be able to hear their own voice, so I have no idea what the pitch is. And boy, I can tell you from experience last week with my own terrible performance, it can be challenging.
This start was the funniest start in the history of headphone karaoke.
Yeah, it didn't. Bohemian Rhapsody did not go.
It was such a great start.
Yeah, it did not go well for me.
You think it went bad. I think it went amazing.
Oh, you thought it was great. Okay.
Yeah.
Well.
You hit 18 notes in one note.
I'm just trying to find it. Yeah. Couldn't find it. It was there somewhere. So I look for it. So we'll see if you guys do that today. What songs are you guys going to be singing here?
I've got Stacy's Mom, which I'm not familiar with.
And okay. I've got The Legend. Oh, I Want to Dance with Somebody.
Oh.
Whitney Houston.
Wow. Okay, very nice.
It's a fun song to dance to.
It is a fun song to dance to. Okay. All right. Who wants to go first?
Go, why don't you go first?
No, Age Before Beauty.
Come on, it'd be good if you go first.
It'd be good if you go first.
All right. I got to borrow your glasses, please. Virginia got new bifocals, and I can't believe it.
No, these are called readers. They're readers.
We wear the same kind of bifocals, Kevin. Same prescription.
Okay.
I got new readers, so we got new readers.
These are kind of make me feel cool.
Hey, don't break them over their hamburger hands.
They look good on you.
So I can't see Kevin, but boy, I can read again. I can't believe I can see this.
It's a whole new world.
It's very important.
It really is.
Very
it's
important.
Happy.
Okay. All right, Jaber with our first performance here.
Okay, I have to hit that button.
Oh, I don't know which one it is.
Just hit me. There we go.
Okay. All right.
Oh, I want to dance with somebody. Who? I want to feel the heat with somebody. Yeah. Oh, I want to dance with somebody. With somebody who loves me. Oh, I want to dance with somebody.
Yeah.
I want to feel the Kev with somebody. Yeah. I want to dance with somebody. With somebody who loves me. Woo!
Okay. Woo! All right. There you go. All right. That is the Birds' performance here today. All
those
right.
Hip thrusts are going to be hard to beat.
Man, it's so nice to see.
Okay. All right. In a second, we're going to have the vote here on who did worse with their performance. Okay. Virginia's taking the glasses now, the readers.
Oh, boy.
Here so she can see the lyrics.
I'll hit your thingy so you don't have to worry about it.
Okay. Hit it a little early.
And you're doing Stacy's Mom. Yeah. Stacy's Mom has got it going on.
Here we go.
Okay.
Stacy's mom has got it going on. She's all I want, and I've waited for so long. Stacy, can't you see you're not the girl for me? I know it might be wrong, but I'm in love with Stacy's mom. Mom.
The low part on that. Okay. All right. Wow.
Not familiar.
Okay.
Sound beautiful.
How close will today's competition be? Who do you think did a worse job? Is it Jaybird? Is it Virginia? The people who are on KBJ TV right now on YouTube are the ones that get to decide. The loser is going to be drinking what we call the You Suck Shot. We'll find out who that is coming up next on the KBJ Show.
You go, and now you're right outside. Second ago in our headphone karaoke, we had a head-to-head battle with Jaybird and Virginia. They had the headphones on, blaring. They couldn't hear their own voice, but two stable performances as Jaybird did a little Whitney Houston.
Oh, I want to dance with somebody.
Yeah.
I want to feel the Kev with somebody. Yeah, I want to dance with somebody. With somebody who loves me.
Woo! Okay, how about that? Virginia then did a song she's just not very familiar with, she said. Stacy's Mom. Here's her performance.
Stacy's mom has got it going on. She's all I want, and I've waited for so long. Stacy, can't you see you're not the girl for me? I know it might be wrong, but I'm in love with Stacy's mom.
Okay. Hitting them deep notes there, Virginia. Hitting them deep notes right there.
I didn't know it. I thought it was supposed to go high.
That sounded good.
Okay, who was the worst performer of the two? We're going to our YouTube channel, put up a poll, about 200 votes in. 79% of the vote says the worst performance was done by... Virginia.
Ooh.
Oh, shocker.
Okay. I thought you did good, Pumpkin.
I'm fine. Just make the shot.
This hurts me to make a shot.
Does it?
It does. We got some creamer this week.
Okay, that's good. That's
we're
a good
also
base.
Going to creamer's mix delicious. That with some orange juice.
Okay. Perfect.
Creamer. Because this is what, so we far, call, what we call our base.
That actually might not be bad.
It's old orange.
It's orange Julius.
I know, right? It could be
and
working out.
You know what? And we're going to put a little Fireball in there.
You know I like Fireball.
I was going to say, so far, can I drink this?
So right now, we've got a fun base.
Okay.
Now, here's some fun stuff.
All right.
Oh, salsa?
Let's get some salsa up in there.
Okay, that's good.
Because it does go down smooth, so don't be alarmed by the chunk.
Uh-huh. Jaybird makes these chewable shots.
Also got some mayo.
Yep, it's kind of a staple.
Oh,
all
my
right.
God.
Ew, okay. Boy. A lot of mayo there.
We got a crow's...
Feather?
Feather to stir it.
Okay. Crow's feather. All right. Very nice.
And just a dollop.
Yeah.
Just a dollop.
Yeah. Oh, what is that you poured in there? What is that?
Greek yogurt juice.
Ew. Yeah. A Greek yogurt juice. Where'd you get that Greek yogurt?
From our sales fridge.
Ah.
It's probably expired.
Okay. That one's gnarly.
Cheers.
Okay. There you go. Knock her down, Virginia.
Oh, she's going for it.
Yeah, she did.
She's doing the whole thing. Wow, look at that. Look at champ.
There. Nice job, Virginia.
Rocco's mom has got it going on.
Whoa, I smell, I think, that yogurt, man.
Yogurt.
That's strong.
Let me see what year that
whoa.
Is.
Oh, it's probably expired.
That,
oh,
that
you know, I can't
right.
see the... Can I borrow your glasses again so I can see the expiration date?
Never.
Never.
I got to make sure you can't read the words. If I compete against you again, I can't give you my glasses.
What a difference that makes to be able to see.
Right.
I
just...
gave you my glasses and you kicked my ass.
Yeah.
The only thing I had going for me was that you couldn't see.
Mm-hmm. All right, well, we have got our All Things Awful bracket. Today's the final day of voting before we go to the Elite Eight tomorrow. really the ones that you can go and decide on right now if you go to kbjshow.com. We started with 64 of the worst things in life, things that were just completely awful that people hate. The closest still is hackers versus HOAs.
Really?
Still.
Hackers should beat HOAs. And look, I hate my HOA. It's run by a little man who thinks he's a king of a kingdom. HOAs suck, but hackers are way worse.
Hackers winning by 5 votes.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. So that's really tight.
It should be not as tight.
Taxes versus scammers is not decided yet. Taxes has a solid lead on scammers, but that could still flip. Everything else is pretty much set in stone. STDs is going to beat rectal exams. Inflation is going to beat mosquitoes. Infidelity is going to beat kidney stones. Still kind of a little surprised by that.
I think that's going to be one that you're going to see in the top 4.
When you pass the kidney stone, it's over, baby. But infidelity can hurt you for years.
For some, a lifetime.
That's true.
Looks like we've got arguing politics over menstruation. I say that's safe.
Yeah, but you've never menstruated, so you can't vote.
She's got a good point. That's why I think that's a little skewed. I think politics is going to beat them because you're right. If you're a dude,
you're like,
men's sex doesn't bother me.
Yeah, okay. And the ones without a doubt, murder and cancer, cruising.
Yeah, cruising. They're going to be in the finals.
It's going to be hard to take them down.
Who do you think wins, though, if they wind up head-to-head in the championship?
Murder.
Cancer's got more votes right now.
Cancer is more outreaching, life-touching,
hits more people
and their families.
Yeah.
I hear you and I see you, and I've changed my mind. Thank you.
Okay.
You're right. You're absolutely right.
You're so easy.
Well, you guys brought up good points.
Final day of voting on the All Things Awful bracket. That ends today. So go to kvjshow.com and cast your votes on that. The FAU men's basketball team, they did not last very long in the NCAA tournament. They are already gone, and their coach is already packed up and is living in Ann Arbor, Michigan.
But how is your bracket doing, Kevin?
Terrible. I'm still in last place, and I'm losing to the dog and grandma.
FAU is one and out?
Yeah.
That's rough.
Didn't go well.
FAU is doing better than Kevin.
No, maybe they... I don't remember. Gosh, it's all such a blur. I honestly checked out after I found out I'm losing to a French bulldog.
That
Nocho.
Is hysterical. And your mother-in-law, who never watches basketball,
had no idea. No, she had no idea. In fact, the team she picked to win it all is already out of the tournament.
Now, if the dog
she's
wins,
she's still beating me somehow.
Is their take snossages? Is that what they get?
Him playing is what won it. Because what we did, we took pieces of chicken nuggets and we put it down with the higher or lower ranked seed, and that's how he was so happy. It was probably the best day of his life. Ocho's a chow hound. That dog loves to eat all the time, and so I was holding him. I'd let him go, and he was so confused. He didn't know where to go. He's like,
chicken. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Think about if you were a dog, then all of a sudden someone's feeding you fried chicken.
But it's the same thing though. And you don't know to go right or left. He was so like, it's like his mind was just like, he didn't know where to go with it. But he loved it. He had so much fun. He had so much fun. And he was so quick because he got towards the end. He knew I was going to try to grab him. So he would pounce so fast from one nugget to try to get both of them. It was, man, those reflexes had to be on. So yeah, I'm losing to that. By the way, Ocho the dog, the last round, only missed one game.
Wow, Ocho.
Unbelievable.
We gotta let that dog pick the lotto numbers for the Powerball.
It's not a bad idea. Not a bad idea. He's got
we should
hot
put
hand.
The dog up against Jaybird and see who gets more numbers.
I'm terrible. No, just go with Ocho.
Ocho wins everything, yeah. Well, FAU already has a brand new men's basketball coach, John Jacus, I believe is his name. He's an assistant coach at Baylor. He had also been at Gonzaga, another good basketball school. He is now going to be the next head coach, taking over for Dusty May. Signed a 5-year deal worth $1 million a year.
Okay.
Yeah. Not bad. I take that, right? Not a bad gig.
That should get you a one bedroom, one bathroom in Boca.
Maybe. Yeah, take him to the bad part of Boca. Go get him a house. All right, coming up here in a couple minutes. Do you have an unusually strong opinion about something? We'd love to hear what it is. We got a long list of your previous texts. We'll take some new ones as well. Go ahead and sound off right now. 877-979-WRMF. Call or text in to the KVJ show.
Once the flight had flown, with the wilt of the rose. I slept all alone, but you still wouldn't go. Let's fast forward to 300 takeout copies later. I see your profile and your smile on unsuspecting waiters. You dream of my mouth before it called you a lying traitor. You search in every maiden's bed for something greater. Baby, was it over when she laid down on your couch? Was it over when he unbuttoned my blouse? Come here, I whispered in your ear in your dream as you passed out. Baby, was it over then? And is it over now? When you lost control, red blood, white snow, blue dress on a bow. Your new girl is my clone. And did you think I didn't see there were flashing lights? At least I had the decency to keep my nights out of sight. Only rumors about my hips and thighs and my whispered sighs. Oh Lord, I think about jumping off a very tall somethings just to see you come running and say the one thing I've been wanting. But no, let's fast forward to 300 awkward blind dates later. If she's got blue eyes, I will surmise that she'll probably date her. You dream of my mouth before it called you a lying traitor. You search in every model's bed for something greater. Baby, was it over when she laid down on your couch? Was it over when he unbuttoned my blouse? Come here, I whispered in your ear in your dream as you passed out. Baby, was it over then? And is it over now? With flashing lights, at least I had the decency to keep my nights out of sight. Only rumbles from my hips and thighs and my whispered sighs. Oh Lord, I think about jumping off a fairy tale somethings just to see you come running, running and say the one thing I've been wanting. But no.
All right, we want to hear your random strong opinions. What random thing do you have an unusually strong opinion about? We all got them, so I know you got one to text to us, 877-979-WRMF. Ashley just texted in. She said, if you can't handle wearing heels for the whole night, don't wear them. I will never walk barefoot in a club or on the streets of Clematis. I feel like I could contract a disease. It is a baffling thing. My daughter has a pair of shoes she loves. She says they're so cute and they're so trendy. I can't even tell you what brand they are.
Well, that's where you need to tell us what brand they are. It matters to the story.
Yeah, I don't know if she's awake now because where she is very early, but I might have to text her because it's unreal. Her feet are getting mangled to the point where they're probably going to scar the cuts in the backs of her heels. Unbelievable.
From the shoe?
From the shoe. I'm like, how can this be a high quality shoe if it is shredding your feet? And why would you wear it? She's like, nah, they're super cute.
I've tried on the Louboutin, and those to me are so uncomfortable on your feet. I can't wear them, most of them, not all of them. But if you told me I had to wear those to be trendy, I'm just not going to be trendy, because trendy without comfort is no life.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay. We should establish that. That's sensibility, correct?
That is sensibility. You can't be tearing up your feet, girl.
I'm trying to get through to my daughter, and it's just not working because it's suck yeah. All right, here's another random strong opinion. It says, you know you're rich when people stop asking what you're wearing, and they start asking who you're wearing. Me, Kirkland at Costco. I think that comes from that page. I'm oddly fascinated with that, too. That woman who's going around Worth Avenue.
Class of Palm Beach.
Ever since that Palm Royale has come out, I've been watching that. Yeah, where they go around Worth Avenue on Palm Beach and like, okay, who are you wearing? And like, okay. And they're like, I'm wearing da da da.
I've been waiting for you to ask. I'm so glad we accidentally ran into each other on Worth Avenue. I've only been standing out here for an hour and a half waiting for you to notice me.
I get what Bird does now. I hate it, but I love it and I need it.
Yeah.
I'm watching it. I don't want to, but I can't tear away. All right. What do you think about this random strong opinion? Ice cream cake is not cake. It's just a brick of ice cream. Stop calling it cake.
It really is shaped like a cake, but it is ice cream. You're right. It's really not a cake.
Huh. Okay.
The black crunchy things, I guess.
Are the star.
They are the star. Does that separate the ice cream from cake? I don't know if it does.
They think that, okay, they just don't like the description. They almost feel like it's a lie.
But it looks like a cake.
It does look like a cake.
But they're saying it's just a brick ice cream.
Cake shape. I think now you're a cake?
We're arguing snack semantics. I love it, but I don't think there's any winners here. I think you go round and round with this.
You just have to probably just punt and take your own side. This person said, my random strong opinion, I can accept that I am a balding, fat, middle-aged man, but I refuse to accept that the smoking hot younger woman with big boobs who likes a post of mine from 5 years ago is a bot, scammer, or online porn vendor. Guys, bless I gotta tell you, I have such a false sense of confidence now, and I don't know what's happened to X ever since Elon Musk took over, but there are so many hot bots on there now, and they all like me, Virginia. They've found me. I mean, my followers, it's just like a runway show of models.
Bless your heart.
And, you know, in a sense, it does. I know it's not real, but my self-esteem has ticked up a bit because of it.
Unless these are friends of Caitlyn, they're not liking your stuff, Dada.
I know that. But I just don't want to face the reality. This person said, I positively loathe my birthday. I really don't see what I would be celebrating. I wish I could donate it to some little kid who would be ecstatic to have two every year.
Huh. Yeah, I hate my birthday too. I'm not a big fan of it. I think we should, once you get past the age of 20, I think we should celebrate it once every decade and then make
you
it
hit
special.
That new mark, yeah.
When
I got
you. 40, big party. You at 50, big party.
I love that idea. That's actually pretty good.
Yeah, I do too.
Because what's special about 37?
Nothing.
Yeah.
Nothing.
Right. Okay.
What are you turning this year?
I don't want to talk about it. I'm 47 this year.
47 okay. This year.
But I've been saying I've been 47 since Jan 1. That's what I do. Every year of my birthday, I just accept the I go, you're in your 47th year. Just start saying you're 47 now. So I'm already used to it.
Okay.
Gotcha.
All right, another random strong opinion. If it takes you longer than 30 seconds to explain your email address to somebody over the phone, you should get a new one that's easier to communicate.
Yeah, ours are terrible. I'm so mad at mine. Our stupid agent that we had told me to pick mine, and I was like, okay, I'll do whatever you say. I'm stupid.
It's so funny.
It's so long. And I'm like, why would you pick this, you idiot?
I did the same thing about the same agent you're talking about. She did the same spiel on me, and every time I go to email somebody, I go, damn you, why did I listen to her?
It's such a long, dumb thing. Make it easy. Make it short.
Mm-hmm. And how do you feel about this random strong opinion? One of the biggest scams we just accept is hotel stays not being an actual 24 hours. If I check in at 3 p.m., that's when I should be allowed to check out.
I agree with that. It is pretty messed up that you can't check in till 3, but they want you out of there at 11 a.m. now.
That's a great point.
And if you call to ask for a late checkout, they act like you're asking for their firstborn. Like, right. Oh, I don't know.
Yeah. It should be understood. I'm paying for a day stay.
You just reminded me of something that I've got a strong opinion about.
Yep.
If you pay for a 90-minute massage or a 60-minute massage, shouldn't that be a 60-minute massage, a 90-minute massage? Not this weird 10 minutes of we're going to prep and we're going to get dressed. It takes me 3 seconds to get undressed. I don't need 10 minutes.
Prove it. Prove it, big dog.
I got a clock.
3 seconds, Kevin?
Yeah, I know. I can get down quite a bold claim.
Set the timer.
I can get down to my underwear and hat and...
Oh my gosh. Wait, give them a chance to sign on to KVJ TV because I know the ladies want it.
Yeah, and you can also go back and get this on demand should you need to, and I think you should.
Okay, Big Sexy, you got 3 seconds and we want to see all right. It all.
On your mark, get set, and go. Okay. He's got pants off.
Go.
He's going for the shirt.
Go.
And he
underwear off.
Underwear off.
Underwear off.
Socks.
Underwear
socks.
Off.
Socks. And kaboom. He just can't get up.
He's struggling.
Okay.
You ever see when a turtle goes on their back?
I'll give you a little credit. I'm going to give you 8 seconds.
I'm trying to help. I can't. My hair
that's
is
not bad. Up. That's actually not bad.
He was about 4 seconds, and all he had left was his
socks.
Drawers.
No, you're right. Yeah.
I proved my point, I think.
Yeah,
I
then you can do it.
I don't need 10 minutes of just give me my 60-minute massage.
Okay. Yeah, I hear you. Strong point.
Shake that thing, girl. Right. Put that on KVJ TV. We need to get them numbers up.
All right. This is not going to do that.
Strong opinions. Text them in to us, 877-979-WRMF. Hopefully you are ready to laugh because Denny's got some jokes for you next.
From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
StormSmart provides homeowners with storm catcher screens. The leading hurricane safety product on the market, StormSmart screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-60-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation. Florida's Turnpike northbound is still shut down in Broward County, this at Atlantic Boulevard. Traffic is backed up to Commercial Boulevard. You can use Lyons Road, 441, or I-95 as alternate routes. From the 850 WFTL Traffic Center, I'm Evelyn Romo.
Hard Rock Bet presents Legal in Florida.
You can bet the game on Hard Rock Bet. No more betting inside your head.
A no-regret first bet up to $100 when you sign up now. Offered by the Seminole Tribe of Florida. Must be 21 and over and physically present in Florida to wager. Terms and conditions apply. Concerned about gambling? Please call 1-888-ADMITTED.
On an MSC cruise, beauty is everywhere. It's in the thrill of a water slide, top-notch entertainment, and in quieter propellers. It's in the sunset and that toast on your very first night on board. Discover the beauty of Ocean Key, MSC's private island marine reserve, and more destinations with up to 40% off cruises, plus drinks, Wi-Fi, and more included. MSC Cruises, for a greater beauty. To book, visit msccruises.com or contact your travel advisor. Restrictions apply. Ships registered in Panama, Malta.
Your floors can go from clean to dirty fast. From juice spills, whoops, to muddy paw prints, to little sticky finger marks. Good thing your Swiffer WetJet works fast, too. Swiffer WetJet easily cleans everyday messes as quick as they happen. The next mess is right around the corner. So grab your Swiffer WetJet and just spray, push, all clean.
Have you been injured in a bicycle accident? The injuries can be devastating. Rubenstein Law has been representing accident victims for over 35 years. We're proud to have a fully English and Spanish-speaking firm with 20 offices in Florida, New York, New Jersey, and Massachusetts. We've recovered billions for our clients. If you or a loved one has been injured in a bicycle accident, call us now. Rubenstein Law, 1-800-FL-LEGAL, office in West Palm Beach. We're open on weekends, too.
If you're like me, obsessed with slowing down or stopping the hands of time, if you love anti-aging, you're going to love the team at Begin A New Med Spa in Jupiter, right there on Indian Town Road, because this is what they specialize in, anti-aging, helping you feel better, whether it's from the inside out or the outside in. You know, I love doing that blood work. Jay Bird, my buddy, just did his blood work. It's peace of mind when you know what's going on with your blood, with your organs, with your nutrients. And at Begin Anew, they're going to tell you everything with your blood work and then make recommendations. Maybe you need hormone replacement. Maybe you need more vitamins. Maybe you need help with specific organ function. They can zoom in on it and help you with everything. If you're looking to lose the weight, semaglutide, y'all, it works. Drop my name, get $75 off the cost of your weight loss program. Go online today, book your appointment, beginanewmed.com.
The Jeep Celebration event is going on right now with exceptional offers on a wide selection of Jeep brand vehicles. If you're looking to supercharge your next adventure, look no further than America's best-selling plug-in hybrid, the Jeep Wrangler 4xe. Or choose the luxurious Grand Cherokee or Grand Cherokee 4xe. All celebrations must come to an end, so hurry and visit Jeep.com or your local Jeep brand dealer for great deals during the Jeep Celebration event. Based on 2022 CYQ4 sales, J.D. Power retail sales data. Jeep is a registered trademark.
Strax Aesthetics unlocks the secret to great cosmetic surgery. Have surgery now and pay later. Breast augmentations and tummy tucks less than $150 per month for qualified patients. Extreme weight loss with a gastric sleeve procedure. The Strax Med Spa offers Botox for $9.99 per unit and unbeatable prices on Juvederm. Guaranteed to beat any comparable quote. Schedule a free face-to-face consultation with your actual board-certified surgeon. Saturday appointments available too. Visit StraxPlastics.com or call 954-749-3040 for more info.
Here at Massey, we've seen the damage termites can cause. That's why we've been protecting homes from termite damage for almost 100 years. Our termite protection program, featuring Always Active Centricon system, doesn't just protect your home from termites, it gives you peace of mind. That's why our termite protection guarantee covers your home and everything in it. Schedule your free inspection today at MasseyServices.com. Massey Services. Expect more and get it.
We are proud of our parents.
Want to know why?
Because they work for the school district of Palm Beach County.
There's lots of great jobs.
With paid vacation, holidays off, health care, and retirement.
You can be on the same schedule as your kids.
Come work at the school district of Palm Beach County.
You'll see why it's your best choice.
Join us at the Team Palm Beach Schools Job Fair. Register at palmbeachschools.org/jobfair. That's palmbeachschools.org/jobfair.
Experience the Anajar and Levine difference. Call 1-800-747-FREE.
From the Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach Studio.
We want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
This is 97.9 WRMF Palm Beach.
Here's what's coming up on the Dirt of the Day. Dirt of the Day.
I mean, Kevin Ralston has been doing the work, unearthing the audio that you want to hear from specifically people that claim Diddy shot me. Their story coming up in your dirt.
Entertainment updates 5 minutes after every hour from the KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF.
Who wants to laugh their ass off? Ooh, I know I do. He wrote some funny punchlines just for me and you. It's Danny's Joke Jury.
Who's ready to laugh?
Oh, you know we are. Time for a little Joke Jury. And what we got for you here today is Danny's doing a little bit of comedy. We're going to let him know what is hitting and what is missing in the jury. What you got for us today, Danny's?
All right, joke one. What do you call a Sith Lord with joint pain?
A Sith Lord with joint pain. I don't know. What would you call that?
Darthritis.
Wow. Darthritis. I mean, talk about writing jokes for your friend Jaybird.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh. Okay, solid.
Second joke. What type of women do pirates find attractive?
I don't know. What kind of women do they find attractive?
Scurvy.
Oh, scurvy.
They like them scurvy women.
Scurvy, yes. In all the right places.
Third joke. How do crabs get around town?
I don't know. How do crabs get around town?
They use a sidewalk.
How? Because they walk
side.
They walk on the sideways.
Oh, they do. Okay. All right. I don't know a lot about crabs.
A little crab humor, a little learning.
You like your audience when you do a comedy. Oh, really?
You know what? His comedy's educational. That's good. I learned something I didn't know.
It really is.
You laugh, you learn, you live, you love.
There's a lot going on there.
Crabs, side note, delicious.
They are. They're tasty.
It might be my favorite crustacean, mate.
We're not talking crab murder.
Crawfish, then crab.
And lobster.
Popcorn shrimp.
Fourth joke. What did they name the new Mormon gymnasium?
I don't know. What did they name that?
Jehovah's Fitness.
My God, that actually is amazing. That's a banger right there,
that's
dude.
That's so good.
That's really good.
And final joke for you guys. How did the swimmer get to second base?
I don't know. How did the swimmer get to second base?
He did the breaststroke.
Oh. Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Very salacious.
I mean, come on.
It's so sexy.
Jehovah's Witness. I mean, come on. There you go.
It's the KVJ dirt of the day. It's the KVJ dirt of the day. Virginia, take it away. Because you know we need that dirt of the day.
Well, there's been so much to come out about Diddy. I feel like everybody who's got a Diddy story now feels like they can tell it without fear of Diddy offing them. And I think one of the juiciest ones comes from a girl named Natania Rubin, who says Diddy shot her in the face.
Yeah, now this is something that you didn't necessarily expect because, you know, from the story that you had heard back in the day, you thought that, you know, it was this shooting that happened in a nightclub that involved Diddy and Shine, another rapper, I guess, S-H-Y-N-E.
Shine supposedly took the fall for Diddy and he got paid $1 million to do so.
Uh-huh. Okay, well, she is saying that Diddy actually shot her in the face, and she is saying it is Diddy that is the trigger man, not Shine.
I literally watched them pull out the guns. I've had a clear point of view. I mean, for God's sake, I got shot in my nose. I was facing them directly. I watched everything occur and have described it, you know, vehemently to all parties involved.
Huh. Wow. J-Lo, you got explaining to do.
Well, that's the part that starts to get interesting for Jennifer Lopez, because in her interview, Natania was talking about how J-Lo was the one that actually carried the gun for Diddy.
It says Jones claims in the lawsuit, Mr. Combs shared that he was responsible for the shooting in the nightclub in New York City with rapper Shine. He shared that artist and Mr. Combs' girlfriend at the time, Jennifer Lopez, aka J-Lo, carried the gun into the club for him and passed him the gun after he got into an altercation with another individual. So now you have Little Rod in this new lawsuit saying that Diddy told him that he actually was responsible.
I just watched that brand new J-Lo documentary. She did not say anything about that, Virginia.
She didn't say she hid the gun for Diddy that he used to shoot some chick in the face.
She kind of skimmed over that part of her life.
Well, and the real problem for J-Lo here is there was a grand jury. She testified and said that she did not. So if that's the case, she perjured herself and lied on the stand.
Jenny from the block lied.
And Natania Rubin saying she would like to have this case reopened.
J-Lo testified at the grand jury, as did many other people. It needs to be reopened, because if that is in fact the case, she carried the gun in and she lied to the grand jury.
Okay.
See, she was crying in her documentary about, I mean, I don't even know what she was crying about in her documentary. It was that bizarre. She should have been crying about this.
Yeah, no doubt.
Maybe she is, but she's not saying she is. Mm-hmm. Did anybody die? Nobody died, right? Because the girl that got shot in the face is the only one that got shot?
She had nine fragments in her face, she was saying, though.
So. Yeah.
And just one person took a bullet? That's it?
Mm-hmm. Yep. That's what happened. So who knows what will happen with that.
And that's just one incident that J-Lo could have seen.
Oh, I know. Sure, there's a lot, and you know the stories just keep coming out. A lot of it from this $30 million lawsuit from Lil Rod. I mean, the names in this are great too. 50 Cent's ex, Daphne Joy, is an OnlyFans model, and she was with 50 Cent for 1 year, beginning in 2011. They wound up having a son together, Sire, in September of 2012. Well, apparently 50 Cent has just found out that. You know, maybe she was getting hired by Diddy to do some sex work and was part of the sex trafficking ring. And maybe that's one of the reasons why 50 Cent hates Diddy so much. And I think he's serious, but 50 Cent is right now making a documentary called Diddy Do It.
I mean, the name on point.
It's just... there's so much. It's so good.
That would be a good documentary.
It's so good. And there's another accusation, too, that Young Miami, the rapper from Miami.
Okay, aptly named.
He's accused of transporting pink cocaine, known on the streets as, I guess, Tucci.
Oh, Barbie Coke.
Yeah, it's, I guess.
Very topical. Very topical.
It's a combination of ecstasy and cocaine, and that drug mule that just got arrested... apparently was part of getting the pink cocaine to Diddy. And so he got the pink cocaine, got it to Young Miami, who hopped on a private jet to fly from Miami to wherever Diddy was just to deliver the pink cocaine.
And we talked yesterday about some of the adult parties that Diddy would throw. Did you see the list of drugs that would be delivered to?
No.
They were all drugs that make you a little bit more loose and a little bit carnal. And a
touchy-feely.
Those type of. That was just running wild, and they said those parties would last up to 3 days.
Oh, my God. Wow. Exhausting.
Hey, well, you don't go to bed on that stuff.
Right.
No, thanks.
Oh, my God.
That does not sound fun. No. All right. Well, there is other stuff besides Diddy. Did you see Rick Ross was named an official ambassador for the West Palm Beach Fire Department on Monday?
Rick Ross?
They gave him an official custom-made firefighter helmet with his name on it.
Oh, he was so proud of it, too.
Biggest boss, Ricky Roseanne, the day I became an official ambassador for the West Palm Beach Fire Department. I had the opportunity of speaking of what it means to be a leader at their leadership conference. I appreciate my helmet. For the ones that may ask, no, this had nothing to do with Tyreek Hill house situation. And no, I didn't know if it was electrical or cloth burning. No, it was just a neighbor of mine saying it looked like Andre Rison's situation. And I was like, not to me, my fire department homie just be telling me when the smoke look like that, it's electrical.
So he gave a completely inaccurate report on social media of a fire, and for that, he becomes a local ambassador for the West Palm Beach Fire Department.
Don't forget to try the Wingstop.
Exactly. What?
Oh, my goodness. Wow. Congratulations.
I like my wings grilled, just like Tyreek's house.
Yeah.
Jason Kelce is being pursued for the Monday Night Football pregame show. Have you seen this?
No. Yeah. They were talking about how he might be one of the hottest commodities out there in football because he comes off just so likable and entertaining.
He is good on the mic,
and
y'all.
Now, yeah, and they're trying to get people that are a little bit, you know, not so buttoned up, and they want to get former athletes and things like that out there that are entertaining.
I think he is a get.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, one of the things that happened was on their podcast, the Kelce brothers were debating about who can drink more. And Travis thinks that he can drink more than his brother, Jason.
At a drinking contest, yeah. I'm pretty sure I've beaten Jason the last 3 to 5 times.
He's on a this chug-off. Is completely made up. First of all, what's the competition? We're talking about chugging? Just chugging a beer? Yeah, well, I can definitely drink more volume. I don't even think that's a question.
What?
Okay.
Now, this is the kind of competition I am here for. Yeah.
It's Virginia who can drink the most on the show.
Yes.
Is it her that can drink the most? Because she's smaller, and I don't know if she drinks as much.
I'm open on Saturday if you are, bitch.
I would not take her on, no. In fact, other people have, like, some of my daughter's friends wanted to challenge her. I'm like, don't do it. Like, just no.
I'm not scared of the witch.
You're not?
You
okay.
should be.
Although, you're right. The last 3 times she's handed me a cup of potion, I've blacked out.
You lost your mind. I looked out the back of my house, and he's on the golf course yelling at the moon.
She gave
what the hell is this werewolf doing?
At one event, she gave me a check for my appearance. I'm like, why are you giving me this? And she talked me into taking the check.
I don't know where it's at.
You never cashed it?
No. I told you not to give it to me.
Oh, if you didn't cash it, I can get it reissued.
Can I get it reissued?
I got to go check my books.
Oh, boy.
I got to go make sure you didn't cash it. Maybe you were drunk when you cashed it, too.
No. I never made it to Palm Beach County.
There's another really amusing kind of sportsy story here because Sage Steele was on ESPN for a very long time, and now she's not. And
who's that?
She was one of the sports reporters that they had on there. She had been on ESPN for a long, long time.
Sage Steele.
Sage Steele.
Is that her Christian name?
I believe it is, yeah. Yeah, true professional.
She was meant to be a broadcaster.
So now she's kind of doing her own independent show that does out there on a different platform. And she was talking to UFC founder Dana White. I don't know if you know him, but he's kind of a muscly kind of looking dude that's bald.
Talks like this.
He kind of looks like Joe Rogan. If you blur and it's kind of in a dark room, he kind of looks like Joe Rogan, sort of.
Yeah, so Sage Steele, the true professional, is talking to UFC founder Dana White for 90 minutes when she asked this question.
What's Joe Rogan's dream?
What's Joe Rogan's dream?
Joe Rogan, Dana White. What's Dana White's dream?
Did you just think that was Joe Rogan?
I totally did.
She just called me f***ing Joe Rogan. You thought I was f***ing Joe Rogan?
Yeah, I thought you were Joe Rogan.
I was bald before Joe was ever bald.
I know.
Just did a 2-hour podcast. I flew here from Vegas, and she thought she was interviewing Joe Rogan.
Jesus.
She thought she was interviewing Joe the whole time?
Wait.
She got the two confused at the end. Now, it's 90 minutes.
In the beginning,
minutes.
Did she know?
I'm hoping she did. I think at the end, she just kind of had a brain fart, and she's like, so, and asked the question.
But she said she thought she was talking to Joe Rogan, which makes me think, did she think she was talking to Joe Rogan the entire interview?
It's 90 minutes, dude.
Oh, my.
Well, now you know why she's a former ESPN host.
Kevin, I swear, I did not know that story existed, but Joe Rogan, they kind of do look alike a little bit.
So in her defense,
both in that fighting world.
Yeah. I know, but nobody handed you a paper and said, you about to talk to Dana White.
Yeah.
I hope that's what really happened, though. She thought she was talking to Joe Rogan the whole time.
It's pretty amazing, right?
Yeah, that's pretty amazing.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what's going on in your dirty dirt.
It's time for viral audio.
Hey, yeah, beautiful hair.
They can't hear me because they're listening to Kids Bop.
We got wings and dick.
There we go.
Got a little new music for you to check out. 21 Pilots. They have announced a new tour that they are going to be going on. Only Florida date I see is going to be the Kia Center in Orlando on September 1st. But along with that announcement came a new...
Monkeys a little bit.
Arctic Monkeys, yeah, absolutely a great band too. And Shawn Mendes has not released an album in 4 years, but now he's teasing what could be some new music on Instagram. Okay. Quiet groove. We'll see if
was he playing that from a computer? Something? Like out of video?
I think so, yeah, on Instagram, yeah. That's what that was all about. All right, coming up here in just a couple of minutes, we got some makeup or breakup email. Somebody wanted to know, does this sign mean my girlfriend is a psycho or not?
Is this J-Lo?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, baby, come on now.
Up in the Escalade, saw the W gate to the valet, knew that it was game when you looked at me, pulling up your sleeve so I could see the roly blade. Saw you later in the corner booth, raising up a toast so I would notice you, but your heart's a mess, think you ought to know, doesn't matter if you're balling out of control.
All I know is that you treat me right, give me all the things I need.
Thought you'd understand, baby, credit cards are in romance. Though you're trying to buy what's already yours, what I need from you is not available in stores. Seen inside of you that I really feel, doing way too much, never keep it real. If it doesn't change, gotta hit the road. Now I'm leaving with my keys, I've got to go.
All I know is that you treat me right, give me all the things I need.
we go.
That's the remix.
That's the new remix. Yeah, she just put that out.
That thing's going off. It's going off in the clubs.
It's going off. Yeah.
Just hope it don't go off on your face.
It did go off in the clubs. You're right. All right, we got some make-up or break-up emails here. Do you need to stay in this relationship or get out? This person wants to know if their girlfriend is a psycho. Just from this, it says, my girlfriend is able to conjure up a stream of tears on command. She doesn't need to be sad. In fact, she demonstrated this the other day to show my sister just how she could do it, and she immediately broke right out of it in a fit of laughter. My sister then pulled me aside and she said, you know, I think this girl's psycho, man. You need to run. She said, look, she is a master of manipulating emotion and she's going to use this as a tool against anybody she pleases. My sister tried to convince me that this is just not normal. I think my sister's being a little bit dramatic about it. I mean, how do you describe actresses, right?
Right.
Are they all psychos? Would you leave somebody over this?
No.
I don't think so either.
I think a lot of girls can do this.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Can you do it, Virginia?
I'm not a good actress.
Okay, all right, yeah, that's true.
You've seen the KVJ horror movies. True.
I think you're getting better, though, every year.
Still not great.
Okay, all right. So you don't think that's a troubling sign?
No, I mean, if she's a good girlfriend that just knows how to cry on command, let's not overthink it here. Yeah. She's just a good actress. But it's a good skill set to have. I envy that.
Are you really a good girlfriend if you make up fake tears to get what you want? That's my question.
Has she ever used it on him?
Yeah, if she is somebody that is crying and you feel like she's manipulating you, yeah, then it's a problem. But if she just has that skill set, there's no problem with that at all.
If it's a skill set that you don't see her using against anybody, that's one thing. But I've seen this happen before where somebody's they're very good at whipping up tears when they need to. And it is a power, and it can be used for evil. Guy or girl, this is a not a this is genderless.
Who hurts you, baby?
First of all.
Okay.
So no one can hurt me more than
yourself.
Mm-hmm. No, but it's anyone that can do that, you just got to watch how they use that power, because it can be psychotic. Well,
you know, tell us about the time a girl used it on you and it wasn't real.
I don't want to do that because it's a family member.
Oh, damn.
Mm-hmm. Not my sister.
Those are the best stories.
Don't email my sisters, please. Sometimes people do that.
We know Jay Bird's talking about you on the radio right now, fake crier.
I'm just saying, it's a skill set people can have, and if you use it for evil, you're psychotic.
Hey, be aware of it. No, she has it. And then maybe question it if it seems like she's using it in a manipulative manner, but if she's not, then she just has a skill.
And I think someone here asked, are actors psychotic? A lot of them are.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. But we don't think that's a breakup?
No.
Okay.
Not with the evidence you've brought forth.
Bird, you seem like maybe you're the one. Do you think that's a breakup?
Now she hasn't used it against me, and if it's not something that's an everyday thing.
Okay. Just be aware of it. What about this one? Makeup or breakup email. Want to know about their able-bodied girlfriend who's using a handicap placard. It says, my girlfriend has been using her sister's handicap placard, even though she is not actually handicapped. I've tried to talk to her about this and express my concerns, but she becomes defensive and insists that it's none of my business. She claims that she only uses it occasionally and that she's not hurting anyone. However, I am struggling with this situation because I feel that it is dishonest and unethical. It bothers me to know that she's taking advantage of something that is meant for individuals with disabilities. Is this a big deal or not?
It's a big deal. This shows her character.
Yep.
This shows that she doesn't care about handicapped people.
Yep.
At a lot of places, there's only one or two handicapped spots.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're able-bodied and you take one of those spots, you're a jerk-off.
And there are people who are out there trying to get people doing this so they can put you on social media. And let me tell you, it is not go your way. No one's going to side with the person who doesn't have a disability parking in the disability. It's a no-win situation for everybody.
And you're right. The character issue is doubling down on that, doing something wrong, and then being defensive about it is a bad sign.
This is a breakup. If she won't stop doing it, you got to let her go.
I agree. Because, look, there will be other things. It's not just going to be this. There's going to be a multitude of things that you're going to find problematic in your relationship going forward. Coming up here in a couple of minutes, Got a fun little game that I pulled off of TikTok from Fantasies in Traverse City, Michigan. It is a strip club, if you didn't know.
Are we doing a strip game?
We're doing stripper trivia. I'm going to let you know what the question is. You've got to guess whether or not these strippers will get it right or not.
Okay.
And if you get it wrong, you got to take off an item of clothing.
Again? Okay. For the second time today?
I'm just trying to see your buns,
hon. It's a great idea, Virginia. We'll play next.
From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
Storm Smart provides homeowners with storm catcher screens. The leading hurricane safety product on the market, Storm Smart screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-60-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation. Look out for emergency vehicles in Palm Beach County on I-95 North at 45th Street. The off-ramp right lane is blocked. You're still seeing heavy delays in Broward County on Florida's Turnpike northbound. An accident shut down Florida's Turnpike north between Atlantic Boulevard and Dr. Martin Luther King Boulevard. Traffic is backed up to Commercial Boulevard. You can use Lyons Road, 441, or I-95 as alternate route. From the 850 WFTL Traffic Center, I'm Evelyn Romo.
Macy's VIP sale is here. Use your coupon or Macy's card and take an extra 30% off the latest spring looks from top designer brands. Plus, get 15% off go-to beauty, skincare, and fragrances. Macy's Star Rewards members earn on every purchase, except gift cards, services, and fees. More at Macy's.com/Star Rewards. Savings off regular sale and clearance prices. Exclusions apply.
I have a secret.
Uh-huh.
I use Secret Whole Body Deodorant because more than just my armpits stink.
Oh, can I use it where my bra rubs under my...
Oh, yeah.
And what about down there? You know, my...
Totally. 4 out of 5 gynecologists would recommend it. So I tried it, and now I get 72 hours of freshness from my pits to my...
Ooh, I love that it's a spray.
Me too. And it comes in sticks and creams too. Go get your Secret Whole Body Deodorant.
Rapids Water Park, Mega Thrills, Mega Fun, and coming later this spring, new Mega Mayhem, the first dueling water coaster in Florida. Visit now for spring break and come back for Mega Mayhem with a season pass. Save 45% and get a free souvenir cup now through April 3rd. Only at South Florida's Mega Thrill Capital, Rapids Water Park. It's Mega 2024.
You know, so many of my girlies are in the same boat as me. If you've got kids and you breastfed those children, they suck the life out of your breast. And then you're left with these deflated sand in a tube sock looking boobies. And that's not cute. You know, at the Aqua Plastic Surgery Center, Dr. Rankin has put together a team that specializes in putting your body back the way it was before you had these little tax deductions running around. Dr. Rankin, Dr. Bauermeister, and the female plastic surgeon, Dr. Giselle, they're incredible. They're skilled. They listen. They care. They want you to get that old body back. In fact, in some cases, they make your breasts look better than they looked before you breastfed. You deserve that. You went through so much. Get a better body on the back end. Tummy tucks, mommy makeovers, liposuction. This is the team. AquaPlasticSurgery.com. Now seeing patients in Jupiter and in Boca. You're going to love the way they care. AquaPlasticSurgery.com.
Hi, it's Randy. I see you scrambling, trying to figure out what you're going to do for Easter. Well, Easter's this Sunday, March 31st.
There's no need to stress. We got you covered. The Honey Baked Ham Company has your solution.
With complete Easter meals. I'm talking about Honey Baked's complete Easter meals that are easy and convenient, so you spend less time in the kitchen.
Complete meals, including a bone-in or boneless ham, smoked or roasted turkey breast, and side dishes that are incredible.
There's still time, okay? Don't panic. Visit Honey Baked to place an order for pickup Swing by your nearest Honey Baked Ham location. No reservation or pre-order is needed. That's how easy they make it for you. They've even extended store hours so you have more time to pick up. Honey Baked Ham, this Easter, March 31st, they got you covered. Whether it's Easter brunch or dinner, they've got offerings for you.
Visit honeybaked.com to find a store near you.
Place that order for pickup, find a store near you, and look for those extended hours. Walk-in customers, welcome too. Happy Easter from Honey Baked Ham.
Hey, it's Suits from the KVJ Show, and you have heard me talk about how great I feel after doing the Coastal Weight Loss Secret Program. I've dropped 30 pounds in just 2 months. Mike and Michelle from Boynton did the program, too, and they're joining me today. Now, Michelle, how much weight have you lost so far?
34 and a half pounds.
And how about you, Mike?
53 pounds in 60 days.
That is incredible. And I got to tell you, after doing the program, I know I felt so much better. So how has your life improved?
Well, my clothes fit. I can wear things I haven't been able to wear in months. I have a lot more energy. My joints aren't swollen. I'm not feeling that pain that I used to feel.
How about you, Mike?
I feel fantastic. I have a physical job, and I feel I'm able to do my job better.
What is it you love most about Coastal Weight Loss Secrets?
The simplicity of the program, really. It makes everything, especially if you're working, so much easier. You can prep in advance.
We have a weekly coaching, and I always feel energized after talking to him. He's super in. Yeah. He's excited about your success.
Well, Mike and Michelle, congratulations on all your success. Schedule a free consultation today with Dr. Zuckerman, and you will see what we're talking about. 561-680-3090 or schedule that consultation online at CoastalWeightLawSecret.com.
You know, coming up this weekend, it's Easter, and nothing goes better with Easter than brunch. I love Easter brunch. Berry Fresh Cafe is doing it so good this weekend. Berry Fresh Cafe in Stewart, in Jupiter, in Port St. Lucie, and in Palm Beach Gardens are doing a delicious menu of Easter lobster. I love that. Many lobster choices have been added to their menu for this weekend only in celebration of Easter. If you haven't been to a Berry Fresh Cafe, they only do breakfast, lunch, and a fabulous brunch. It's a recipe for success at Berry Fresh Cafe. Farm to table, scratch cooking. They rotate their menu based on what's seasonally fresh in your area using local purveyors, local farmers, local produce, local protein. This is the kind of eating you want to do. Clean, local, amazing. They even reverse osmosis their water so it tastes better. And the water they cook with is better. Offering a full keto, vegan, vegetarian menu, and don't forget lobster for Easter and a full bar with liquor, wine, and beer. It's Berry Fresh Cafe for Easter brunch.
South Florida weather is 15 seconds away from the H. Gregg West Palm Beach Weather Center.
Score big savings this March at hgregg.com on Military Trail. Check out a slam dunk selection of pre-owned vehicles. They've got the lineup that will make you feel like a champion on the road. hgregg.com, where every drive is a victory lap. Save more, drive happy.
Mostly cloudy this morning. A few light showers or drizzles, too, as temperatures are in the mid-70s. That's a mild start. Even warmer and humid this afternoon with highs in the mid-80s. But a cold front passing through with very breezy conditions and also a few passing showers this afternoon. I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Jennifer Correa on 97.9 WRMF.
This report is sponsored by Morgan & Morgan Injury Law Firm.
I'm John Morgan of Morgan & Morgan. Today, we're the largest injury firm in the world, and I'm thankful to you for trusting us all these years. We'll always be here for the people, not the powerful. We'll always be here for you. Morgan & Morgan.
Visit forthepeople.com for an office near you.
Injured? Visit Lytle Rider, Smith, Ivy, and Fronrath at foryourrights.com.
What you need to know on the KVJ Show.
Know people are all ready for a nice little getaway to Orlando for the Seven Seas Food Festival coming up at SeaWorld Orlando. Now, you got five chances today to qualify. All you have to do is listen up for the code word I'm going to have for you in 15 minutes. You enter into the WRMF app and you're qualified. Four more chances today happen at 11 a.m., 1, 3, and 5 p.m. More times you qualify, better chances of winning this amazing two-night hotel stay, 4 2-day passes, and food and beverage sample lanyards for the Seven Seas Food Festival that is going to be coming up here all day long at 97.9 WRMF. All right, we got a fun little thing here called Stripper Trivia. We got two lovely ladies who are dancers at Fantasies in Traverse City, Michigan, pulled this off a TikTok video with these questions. You just have to guess, are they going to get the question right or wrong?
Oh, I love this.
Okay, our first question that we have for these lovely ladies at Fantasies. If I pay you $100 to dance for three songs, how much money would you be making per song? Okay. What do you think about this? Virginia, do you think that they get it right or not? What are you going to say here?
They get it right.
You're going to say this is easy as a no-brainer?
Totally.
Absolutely. Okay, let's see what their answer is here. How much would you be making per song, ladies?
$50, $70.
Okay, $50, $70. No, that is incorrect. The correct answer would be $33.33.
Dang.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Well, that was hard.
Yeah, and you're just getting to know the ladies, too.
We were.
Yeah. Okay. All right, Jay Bird, the question that we asked these ladies at Fantasies was, what does the D.C. stand for in Washington, D.C.?
No, they do not get this.
They do not get this.
Oh.
Okay, here's their answer.
Democratic Court.
We're looking for District of Columbia. Jay Bird got that correct.
My old school ways of doing drunk girl trivia is kind of kicking back in. I had a feeling she was not going to get that.
That's why he's over there twitching. He's got PTSD from that bit.
Yeah. Okay, Virginia, what do you think about this and some stripper trivia? They're asked to spell the word tequila in this TikTok video. Do they do it correctly? Yes or no?
Yes, they do. Yes. Tequila.
Okay, ladies, spell tequila.
T-E-Q-U-I-L-A.
Yes.
Ah, of course they know tequila.
Suck on that.
Okay.
It's my girl.
All right. Jaber, the question. If Destiny is 5'9" and puts on 6-inch heels, how tall is she? Do they get this correct? Now, you got to listen to this one, because this is a bit of a trick question.
I think she does get it, because you would think there's no way she gets it, but she understands booze, she understands fashion and her wardrobe. I'm going to say she gets it.
You're going to say that she gets it. Okay, now, to let you know, if you have not picked up a little bit of the trick question, the trickery in this question, Destiny is 5'9", no matter what kind of shoes she puts on. She can put on 6-inch heels.
Well, that's not fair.
It's a bit of a twist here, Virginia.
Her height does change when the heel height changes, if we're only measuring the top of her head.
Okay.
I'm on Team Destiny.
Okay, she's not going to get it.
Okay. All right, so you would give her credit if she says 6'3", then?
I would.
Okay. All right, so we'll give her credit. We'll say that's it. She's got to say 6'3", or stick with the original height of 5'9". Jay Bird, do you think she'll get it?
No.
Okay.
No faith in her.
5'9" or 6'3", we'll take either answer for credit. How tall is Destiny?
She's 6'3".
Oh!
Pulled it out at the last minute.
She did. Okay, give her some credit there.
That's good.
Okay, so far Virginia's gotten one correct. Jay Bird has gotten one correct here in our stripper trivia. Okay, next question that we have here for the girls at Fantasies in Traverse City, Michigan. Who did America get their independence from? Virginia. We're looking for the answer of Great Britain, England would have worked.
The UK.
The UK would work. We take that as well. Do they say one of those answers? Yes or no?
I don't think they do.
Bird's shaking his head no.
I want them to. Look, I believe...
Okay.
But I don't believe she's going to get this one.
All right, ladies, who did we get our independence from?
Oh, my goodness. The other countries.
The other.
Well, technically, they are other countries.
Yeah.
The other countries.
I'll give her partial credit on that.
Okay. Right. Virginia, you'll get full credit on that. Very nice. Okay, Jay Bird, next question for the ladies at Fantasies in Traverse City, Michigan here. If you drive 50 miles per hour, how far will you get in an hour and a half?
No, they're not going to get this.
75 miles, I believe, is what we're looking for here.
I mean, that's hard. That's really hard.
There's no way they get it.
Okay, what is your answer, ladies?
Probably like 20 miles.
Okay. All right. Well,
yeah. And if it's about booze or what they're wearing, they're going to get those answers right.
Okay. All right. What about this question here, Virginia? What is the line that goes around the earth that separates the northern and southern hemisphere? Do you think they'll be able to say the equator here?
I do. I think they're going to say the equator.
Okay, ladies.
What, the equator?
Oh,
yes.
Oh, geography.
That's my girl.
Very nice. Okay, and one more question, Bird. Do you think these ladies at Fantasies in Traverse City, Michigan will be able to tell you who's on the $5 bill? They're dealing some cash.
Yes, I'm going to say yes.
You're going to say yes. We're looking for Abraham Lincoln here,
they
if you're
should.
Unaware.
They should. Yeah, I'm going to go, yeah, I'm going to believe in our girls.
Okay, ladies, who is on the $5 bill?
George Washington.
My gosh.
Oh, no.
Good Lord.
Oh, yeah.
Well, they look a lot alike.
Yes, they do, right? There you go.
But you know, these girls, they do like management told me to do. They stay in their lane. They know what they know. They know about high heels. They know about tequila. And really, what else matters?
Okay.
If you give me high heels and you give me tequila, that's a happy life.
You think it's okay? So you're all good.
Good for you, ladies.
Okay. Well, coming up here in a couple of minutes, 7-Eleven clearly has the first April Fool's joke of the season. Is it a good joke or not? I'll let you decide in your whacked out news coming up after Noah Kahan on the KVJ show with Stick Season.
As you promised me that I was more than all the miles combined, you must have had yourself a change of heart like halfway through the drive, because your voice trailed off exactly as you passed my exit sign. Kept on driving straight and left our future to the right. Now I am stuck between my anger and the blame that I can't face. And memories or something, even smoking weed is not replaced. And I am terrified of weather, cause I see you when it rains. Doc told me to travel, but there's COVID on the planes. And I love Vermont, but it's the season of the sticks. And I saw your mom, she forgot that I existed. And it's half my fault, but I just like to play the victim. I'll drink alcohol till my friends come home for Christmas, and I'll dream each night of some version of you that I might not have, but I did not lose. Now your tire tracks in one pair of shoes, and I'm split in half, but that'll have to do. So I thought that if I piled something good and all my bad, that I could cancel out the darkness I inherited from Dad. No, I am no longer funny, cause I miss the way you laugh. You once called me forever, now you still can't call me back. And I love Vermont, but it's the season of the sticks. And I saw your mom, she forgot that I existed. And it's half my fault, but I just like to play the victim. I'll drink alcohol till my friends come home for Christmas, and I'll dream each night of some virgin of you that I might not have, but I did not lose. Now your tire tracks in one pair of shoes, and I'm split in half, but that'll have to do. The sticks, and I saw your mom, she forgot that I existed. And it's half my fault, but I just like to play the victim. I'll drink alcohol till my friends come home for Christmas, and I'll dream each night of some version of you that I might not have, but I did not lose. Now your tire tracks in one pair of shoes, and I'm split in half, that'll have to do.
Ow! There's a lot of dumbass criminals to talk about, baby. It's the whacked out news. People breaking the law. Ha ha, fighting in the nude. Ha, drunk people pooping in the street. Ha ha, it's the whacked out news. So many people are meth. Ow!
Well, Now get ready. We're not there yet, but the jokes are already starting to fall. April Fool's Day is right around the corner.
Thank you for the heads up. That is Monday.
Monday, what a day, too. You're going to be coming off the weekend. You're not going to be thinking about it. There's going to be jokes all over the place.
Be all hungover and somebody get you.
Yep. I think this might be one of our first April Fool's jokes of the season. Tell me if you like it or not. 7-Eleven has announced a new sparkling water that tastes like their Big Bite hot dogs. They're going to give you more details on how to get it on Monday.
Somebody sent that to us, and they were like, oh, my gosh, you guys need to get this for Do It, Bitch. And I was like, yes, we do, girl.
Yeah,
they got both me and our listener.
If it's not real, we could try to make it ourselves.
We could totally make it ourselves.
I feel like we're going to be having hot dog water next week.
We've drank hot dog water before. We just didn't make it carbonated.
Exactly. That's all you got to do. That's a little twist. Okay. So you liking it then?
I love it.
Okay.
You know how to make it carbonated?
Sure, yeah.
Okay.
I gotta add some CO2.
Yep.
I think you just add some sparkling water and you should be.
AKA CO2.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Don't know if you've known this, but the birth rates are plummeting in Japan. And so now a baby diaper company is switching to making adult diapers instead. They have so few babies. Yeah, the population's aging so badly.
That's wild.
Wow. Yeah, how about that?
Huh.
Manufacturing twist. And you hear this? Due to climate change, ice loss is redistributing the Earth's mass enough to make it spin slower. What the heck, man?
Does that make us dumber? Because I kind of feel like that's what's happening.
Okay, you feel like that's the reason?
I kind of want it to spin slower, though. In my honest opinion, it goes too fast, baby.
If the Earth goes slower, does that mean the days go longer?
It is going to change things, yeah. They said by the end of the decade in 2029, we could be losing one whole second, and they'd have to recalibrate our clocks accordingly. You know, we do a leap day. We might have to start doing that kind of stuff with time.
I wonder how many times that's happened in the history through time where they've had to recalibrate not only the time, but the day.
I wonder how many times we've already done this before.
Of course, exactly. Like today's Thursday. But if you go back into the beginning, there's probably different times where it was a Thursday. Like Tuesday was a Thursday.
They didn't have the kind of wherewithal that we do now. I mean, you know, the smart people are looking at the stars. Other people are going, I don't know, it looks dark to me.
And we get smarter and smarter and smarter until we blow this whole thing up with nukes and then we start over again from scratch.
It's crazy we argue about everything, but that was the one thing we all got on the same page with. Oh, yeah, today's Monday. No, it's not. It's Wednesday.
Yeah.
See what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah, thank the Romans. Mm-hmm.
Romans.
There's an old lady in England that thought she found a baby hedgehog on the side of the road, and she rushed it to the vet to get some medical attention. Turned out it was actually just a fluffy pom-pom from a hat.
You big dummy.
She's an old lady, you know.
Oh, she's old.
Oh, I'm going to take the baby hedgehog.
I mean, if anybody needs readers.
Yeah, right.
It's her. I should loan her my new cool readers.
They are awesome.
She meant well. Somebody thought they saw a mountain lion in San Francisco on Tuesday. They reported the news.
Be careful. Those mountain lions are killing people.
Yeah. It's kind of crazy. There's a news reporter that's out there. The reporter went out there and he's like, yeah, somebody's reported a mountain lion. And he turns around and actually it was just a really big house cat and it was sitting right behind him. He's like, I think that's actually a cat.
Well, thank goodness it wasn't a mountain lion.
No, you're right. No, you're right. They had a mountain lion attack out there.
They did. Scary.
A hunter called a police department in Northeast Washington saying he was coming in from out of town next month and wanted to know if it was legal to hunt Sasquatch there. Okay, that's a good question.
Do not kill Sasquatch.
We find him, finally, and some yahoo shoots him and stuffs him.
Oh, one guy that actually finds him shoots him.
We won't handle it right.
Yeah, crazy. A Montana man was busted for driving on I-90 in the wrong direction for nearly 30 miles.
Oh, my gosh. How did he go so far?
He was massively hammered.
Oh, my gosh.
A deputy was following him, and the dude's blowing through red lights, stop signs, everything. The deputy finally passes him, throws down some of those stop sticks, blows out the guy's tires. When they finally got a hold of him, they found alcoholic beverages in the cup holders. He blew a .214, which is more than twice the legal driving limit of .08.
Yeah, so. We're not going to be mad if you rough that guy a little bit up on the way to the station either.
I didn't see anything.
Yeah, he fell on those stop strips.
Yeah. More violence at a gas station, this time in Pittsburgh. The employee of that gas station got arrested for beating a man with a PVC pipe.
Oh, my.
That's going to hurt a little bit.
Oh, my goodness. That
Not
is
as
a
bad
takedown.
As a lead pipe, but a PVC pipe will hurt.
He said he was just fighting back after the man threw a banana at him. It doesn't seem like that's equal justice, though, right? I
no.
chuck a banana at you and... And you beat me down with a PVC pipe?
This guy brought a pipe to a banana fight.
I think a banana fight kind of sounds fun.
Oh, man. A lot more fun than a PVC pipe fight.
Give me the banana.
And a high-speed boat chase drug bust off an island in Colombia netted 3 tons of cocaine.
Wow.
All valued at $113 million.
Was it P. Daddy's pink cocaine?
Yes, it was headed for Diddy's place on Star Island.
Dang.
5 suspects were taken into custody. And that is your whacked out news. All right, the 7 Seas Food Festival. Getting ready to go down at SeaWorld Orlando. We'd love to send you there with a 2-night hotel stay, 4 2-day passes, and food and beverage. Sample lanyards. All you have to do is take the code word FLAVOR, FLAVOR, FLAVOR. Enter it into the WRMF app right now, and you are qualified with FLAVOR.
From the WRMF Anna Jar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anna Jar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
StormSmart provides homeowners with StormCatcher screens, the leading hurricane safety product on the market. StormSmart screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-60-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation. Look out for emergency vehicles in Palm Beach County on I-95 North at 45th Street. The off-ramp right lane is blocked. You're still seeing heavy delays in Broward County on Florida's Turnpike northbound. An accident shut down Florida's Turnpike North between Atlantic Boulevard and Dr. Martin Luther King Boulevard. Traffic is backed up to Commercial Boulevard. You can use Lyons Road, 441, or I-95 as alternate route. From the 850 WFTL Traffic Center, I'm Evelyn Romo.
Demand Dave! 844-411-1LAW. Demand Dave! For car accident or slip and fall. Need a personal injury lawyer?
444-411-LAW. Hamilton is coming. Get tickets today for the Tony, Olivier, Grammy, and Pulitzer Prize winning musical. It's the story of America then, told by America now. Hamilton in West Palm Beach at the Kravis Center from April 10th to 21st. Get tickets at Kravis.org.
Be tired of glasses and contacts? I do not blame you. I have my fill. In fact, I had glasses when I was a youth. I tried contacts in my early 20s. Neither one worked out for me. I was afraid of a LASIK procedure, though. I thought it was going to be painful. I thought it was going to be expensive, and I was wrong on both counts. Let me tell you, it's not at all painful. Laser does all the work. Your vision gets blurry. That's it. Doesn't hurt. Doesn't even tickle. Next day, I was back at work, and I was fine. I was good. My vision was getting better. That was 10 years ago. I'm going to do the other eye this time very soon because I know that I could do this, and I could do it now. Even if I don't have the money, it doesn't matter because they got a payment plan with zero down, zero interest for 12 months. So you don't take out your wallet until 2025. How cool it is. And it's so easy to find Panu, too, with locations all over Broward and Palm Beach. It's made convenient. And, too, it's safe because Dr. Mutiella has the expertise of over 100,000 LASIK procedures. So book today at PanuLaser.com. Drop my name, Kevin from the KBJ Show, to get an additional $500 off. That's PANNULaser.com.
When we made our McDonald's Spicy Chicken McNuggets, you were praise hands emoji. Then we ran out and you were streaming tears emoji. Now they're back, so you can be grinning face with sweat emoji. Order ahead on the McDonald's app.
Spicy Chicken McNuggets are back for a hot minute at McDonald's. Now get 25% off any purchase of $1 or more when you order ahead in the McDonald's app. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Offer valid through April 21st, 2024 at participating McDonald's. Valid once a day. Must opt into rewards. Excludes tax.
When you're drinking a frozen beverage from McDonald's, your brain may not like how refreshingly cold it is.
But the rest of your body? Oh, yes. It's gonna relish every moment of it. Because there are drinks. Then there are drinks from McDonald's.
Try any size frozen drink, like a frozen Fanta Blue Raspberry or a tasty frozen Coke for $1.49. At participating McDonald's, Coca-Cola and Fanta are registered trademarks of the Coca-Cola Company.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. At Charmin, we heard you shouldn't talk about going to the bathroom in public, so we decided to sing about it.
When you're rolling Charmin, I'm just off on the potty. Let's just muscle roll it back, everybody. Charmin's irresistibly soft and hella nice. The crib is always stocked.
It's our potty bite.
It's
Charmin Ultra Soft is irresistibly soft and more absorbent, so you can use less. Enjoy the go with Charmin.
You want a sub made the authentic Jersey way? You go to Jersey Mike's. You want a radio idea? You go to me. Like this. I'm a talking dog that only talks about Jersey Mike's. My owner says, "Hey, buddy." And I'm like, "Get me an authentic Jersey sub." He says, "That's all you ever think about." And I say, "No. I also think about teaching myself to drive the Jersey Mike's, but until I figure that out, you're all I have." Woof, woof. May the authentic Jersey way since 1956. Jersey Mike's, a sub above.
Strax Aesthetics unlocks the secret to great cosmetic surgery. Have surgery now and pay later. Breast augmentations and tummy tucks less than $150 per month for qualified patients. Extreme weight loss with a gastric sleeve procedure. The Strax Med Spa offers Botox for $9.99 per unit and unbeatable prices on Juvederm. Guaranteed to beat any comparable quote. Schedule a free face-to-face consultation with your actual board-certified surgeon. Saturday appointments available too. Visit StraxPlastics.com or call 954-749-3040 for more info.
Business. It's all the things that keep this world turning. And behind every one of these companies is a partner helping to keep it all moving. It's why the local flower shop and your favorite pizza joint, the startup in the stadium, hospitals and hotels, banks and restaurants nationwide, all choose the Advanced Network, Cybersecurity Solutions, and round-the-clock trusted partnership from Comcast Business, the company that powers more businesses than anyone else. Comcast Business, powering possibilities.
See why Comcast Business powers more small businesses than anyone else. Get started with fast speeds and advanced security for $49 a month for 12 months with a 2-year contract when you add one unlimited mobile line. Plus, ask how to get up to an $800 prepaid card with a qualifying gig bundle. Don't wait. Call to switch today. Ends 5/6/24. Restrictions apply. New customers only with 100 megabits per second internet and security edge. Ecobill and autopay required. Equipment, taxes, and fees extra.
Did you know Conky Joe's Seafood Restaurant and Bar has been one of the longest-standing waterfront establishments on the Treasure Coast? Guests have been laughing, making memories, and dining at the Jensen Beach Conky since 1983. Experience the essence of Martin County with Riverside Dining, renowned conch fritters, truly fresh fish, daily happy hour, live music, and Sunday brunch. Come to Conky Joe's to remember what you love about Jensen Beach, just north of the Jensen Beach Causeway. For reservations, visit ConkyJoe's.com or check out their Facebook page.
I gotta tell you, it's really something you gotta look into. These stats will get your attention. Did you know that 1 out of 3 people are gonna die from heart disease? And in 30 to 40% of heart attacks, the first symptom is sudden death. We found out about a place called Life Imaging FLA that is saving lives of people here in South Florida. People go in and they get this 10-minute body scan with no dyes, no need to undress, and then they get the peace of mind of knowing if they've got a heart issue or not. Some people, yeah, they have, but 80% have not. The people that they've saved have gone right to the hospital and could have saved their life right then and there. I'm telling you, get that early detection because it saves lives. And you can get this free heart scan with just a few minimum requirements, a $699 value right now. And while you're there, ask them about their cancer screening and their virtual colonography. Yeah, I don't want the sedation either, and I know you don't. So that's why you need to go and get this free heart scan right now with just a few minimum requirements. All you do is call #250 and say the keyword free heart scan. That's #250, keyword free heart scan.
Experience the Anajar and Levine difference. Call 1-800-747-FREE.
From the Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach Studio.
We want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
This is 97.9 WRMF Palm Beach.
It's Somebody went and found the snack wagon.
You can always tell when they refill the snack bowl, yeah, and our little squirrel goes back there and gets some snacks because he can't help himself but eat snacks right next to the microphone.
That's more fun.
My headphones were down. I couldn't hear nothing. I apologize.
Send the hate emails.
All right, what you got over there, squirrel?
Not my favorite, but we're going to have to make do. We got peanut butter and crackers.
Are they as good as Rocco's? Rocklet chocolate?
Bring on the rocklet chocolate.
Here you go.
So many snacks here.
Rocco made peanut butter cups, and Jay Bird gave them a 10 out of 10.
They were good. I would, too. I would, too. I thought they were excellent. I took a nice, healthy bite. You let Rocco know.
I will. And he'll be so happy.
And that's breaking my ketosis. I did that for him.
Tell Rocco I got a clean bill of health yesterday. I'm eating so much chocolate today.
Yeah. All right, that Seven Seas Food Festival code word you need is flavor, F-L-A-V-O-R. If you didn't get that already, enter it into the WRMF app to get qualified for that trip to the Seven Seas Food Festival at SeaWorld Orlando with the two-night hotel stay, 4 2-day passes, and food and beverage sample lanyards. Another fun thing going on. Today's the day they're really pushing the new Mega Mayhem. I don't know if you heard about this new feature at Rapids Water Park.
No, I love Rapids. Tell me.
It is the longest dueling water coaster in Florida now.
Huh.
Whoa.
Is this the one that took the place where the big old hill with the yellow coaster was?
Yeah, that old one had been around forever. Yeah, they're making it more modern now. Always upgrading there at Rapids.
She was an oldie but a goodie, but I do love that. Rapids reinvests in the property, keeping it fresh and keeping it spicy. I like that.
Yeah, the ride is 54 feet tall, reaches speeds up to 22 miles per hour.
Oh, damn.
And is going to be debuting on April 4th, so not too far away next week.
That's definitely going to give my back of my bathing suit a wedgie.
They're ranked in the top 10 for best water parks in Florida.
They should be.
They're in there.
They should be number one in Florida.
Yeah, that'd be interesting. Do you have who's ranked where on
I
there?
Do.
Who would be one, and then where's Rapids in that list?
They have Discovery Cove as number one, and these are water parks in Florida. I've never been to Discovery Cove. Do they have rides there?
Is that SeaWorld?
Could be. I think that sounds right.
Blackfish. I don't know.
They've got Aquatica. Have you heard of that place?
I have.
Is that fun?
Is that SeaWorld?
Haven't been, I don't think, but I've heard of it.
Shipwreck Island Water Park, you know where that's at?
Don't think I know that one.
Orlando Water Sports Complex.
Don't know that.
Universal Volcano Bay.
Yes, we know that. Yeah, we've seen that one. Yeah.
Is that worth the hype?
That's cool, yeah, yeah.
They've rides there.
It's a massive volcano. It's pretty cool, mm-hmm.
Nona Adventure Park.
Nona Adventure Park.
What is it? Somebody's grandma's running it?
That out of all of the pictures, that one looks the weakest.
Okay, well, we know Rapids beats Nona.
Adventure Island and then Rapids coming in at 10. I think Rapids needs to be... Nona?
Nona, get out of here with that.
Right. Yeah, that doesn't sound...
I will say, I didn't know half these parks existed in Florida, though.
Yeah, they got a good bit. I mean... You know, Rapids, considering, I mean, you know, it's in an odd space, you know, the fact that a lot of those other parks are around other theme parks and things like that.
It's standalone, It doesn't have Disney or Universal or SeaWorld.
Military Trail where it's located and Riviera Beach.
It's been there since I was a kid. Yeah. I mean, I remember them running Rapid commercials. I'm talking Little Jay Bird.
Yeah, it's legit. You know, people who are down south, if you're in Lauderdale, Aventura, Miami, it's worth getting on the Brightline to come up for. It's a good park.
The Rapids did a thing where a supermodel cast. Kathy Ireland was signing autographs for people.
Ooh.
And I was there. My dad took me there because I had a crush on Kathy Ireland. Uh-huh. But so did sweet producer Denny's. He was in the same line as me getting her autograph. We were there together but didn't know each other
yet.
Isn't that weird?
That's like those stories you see on TikTok where like it's a picture of you and Kathy Ireland and you see Denny's in the background.
I would love to know how close me and him got to each other that day because it was one line.
Sure.
Been pretty close.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that is cool. Coming up here in just a couple minutes, what would you say is the best song with whistling in it? Best song with whistling.
Easy.
Okay, you think you got one? I've got all the best ones that are out there. I want to see if you can tell me what you think is the best of all time. Coming up in minutes here on the KVJ Show, a little throwback semi-sonic.
Closing time.
open all the doors and let you out into the world. Closing time, turn all of the lights on over every boy and every girl. Closing time, one last call for alcohol, so finish your whiskey or beer. Closing time, you don't have to go home, but you can't stay here. I know.
How are you guys at whistling? Do you whistle well? Virginia, not so good. Bird? No, not great.
I used to be such a good whistler. I've got the yips when it comes to my whistling.
You put us on the spot. I'm not slicked up over here.
Okay, you weren't ready. Let me get a little ready.
Yeah, hold on.
Lips aren't ready.
Yeah.
Here we go.
No, you're terrible.
No. It's not very good. Virginia, redemption. Yep.
Well, you're not that good either.
Yeah,
you're terrible too.
I'm out of practice. I used to whistle all right.
I was not bad.
Yeah, I don't know what's happened to me. Maybe you got to stay on it.
You were not good.
Yeah. Well, there was never anything in it, but then I found a story about this Molly Lewis. She's actually a professional whistler. That's her gig.
Some people are amazing. They almost kind of sing whistle. Billy Joel does it, where you can hold and change notes within your whistle.
Yeah, there is really something to it. She's got a new whistling album out, and she actually did some work on the Barbie movie. If you watch the Barbie movie, this is her, Molly Lewis.
About that. yeah, we're just doing that lip whistle. They're doing that from below.
Right.
Through the lips.
Yeah.
Which lips? If you whistle in from below, you can take that act on the road, girl.
Okay, so what do you think is the best whistling song of all time? What do you got, Bird?
I got, I'm going to sound like a broken record, Billy Joel's The Stranger.
Okay, very solid. Oh, it's good, yeah. That would be amazing to be able to whistle like that. Oh, man.
And then it kind of kicks into a little rock in there.
That does.
That'd be so easy to fake in concert, though, to play like a whistling track so you don't have to do that live every time.
That'd be tough to do live,
He don't fake his stuff, though. Mm-hmm. That's not what Billy does.
What do you think is the best whistling song, Virginia? Do you have a favorite?
Sitting in the morning sun, I'll be sitting when the evening comes.
Sitting on that dock of the bay, huh?
Watching the tide roll in. Come on. And then I watch them roll away again.
When do they whistle that song?
Because I'm just a sitting on the dock of the bay. I've hijacked your show.
She's just going to sit like a Muppet for about a minute and a half.
And there's no whistling that I can hear in there.
Yeah, they do. They whistle, but it takes a minute. It takes a minute.
Kevin was kind of doing two things at one time. That's the only reason why that lasted for so long.
And then he was busy. He wanted to turn my mic off, but he was busy.
He looked over at me going, what the hell is wrong with her?
Dude, menopause.
I'm not going to lie. I don't think that was your worst work.
No, you do you sing it well.
I did way worse during headphone karaoke.
You did? Where was that?
No. To me, the greatest whistling song of all time is Guns N' Roses' Patience. Can anything compete with that?
Well,
or The Stranger?
Immediately, Slash and Axl Rose got to do a fight because your guitar's too loud. Your whistling's too loud. Let's play.
Probably.
Definitely.
Okay, any other suggestions? Hit us up, 877-979-WRMF.
Thanks for being a part of the KVJ Nation. More next on 97.9 WRMF.
Rosalitas! Rosalitas!
Spice up your life with the best, most authentic Tex-Mex grill in Palm Beach at Rosalita's in Lantana. They welcome you to the award-winning restaurant with only the finest meats, poultry, and fish dishes. A family-run restaurant since 1994. The minute you walk in the door of Rosalita's, you'll smell the aroma of delicious fajitas, burritos, or enchilada. Staff is always ready to serve you with your favorite Tex-Mex dish, such as carne asada, fish tacos, baby back ribs, or Santa Fe salad, spinach, and chicken enchiladas. Or you can always go the lighter side with a tortilla soup and a taco salad. Rosalita's is open daily, starting with happy hour from 11 till 7, lunch and dinner. And there's always something fun going on at Rosalita's with karaoke on Tuesdays and Fridays and live music on Saturdays. What are you waiting for? Come and spice up your life. 561-964-5747 on the corner of Lantana and Congress.
Come and spice up your life at Rosalita's. Rosalita's.
Z-O-O-M-T-A-N. I was tan last summer, now I'm pale again. I need a little bit of help to be ready for the beach. Zoom tan puts some within my reach. Brown as a biscuit for $9.99. ZoomTan.com for a limited time.
Zoom tan, $9.99. Zoom tan.
All copper tans are now Zoom tans. Go to zoomtan.com/radio for $9.99 offer.
Easy Cater presents We've Got Your Back. Up singers.
Backing you up.
So I used to call the restaurant to order teen lunches.
He called the restaurant.
They were super nice, but explaining everyone's dietary needs?
Who has time for that?
But then I found Easy Cater. Vegan, gluten-free.
Gluten-free.
Type in what you need and get tons of restaurants.
Tons.
Now ordering food for work is easy as pie.
And who doesn't love pie?
Easy Cater has your back with over 100,000 restaurants. Order 24/7 on easycater.com and
we got your back.
You know, before I drove a Kia, I had a preconceived notion about Kias. And if you're like me, it's okay. I get it. We all thought that Kia was one thing. Until we drove one of these new Kias, and then you're like, wait a minute, I don't know new Kias. Maybe I know Kias from 10 years ago, but these new Kias, they're totally redesigned, and the people at Greenway Kia have shown me the light. These cars are technologically advanced. They're tricked out. They have advanced technology that even Rocco was like, wait, hold the phone. Some of these cars were nicer than my BMW features. Yeah, at Greenway Kia. And they're overstocked right now because they're doing major construction. They're totally revamping their whole entire building. And so they need to make room for construction. They're moving these cars at crazy low prices, but only at Greenway Kia. If you've got a job making $350 a week, they want to approve you. All you need to do is call 1-800-NEW-KIAS. That's 1-800-NEW-KIAS for Kia West Palm Beach. That is also available online at Kia West WestPalmBeach.com, because we want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
Air conditioner not working? Art can fix it. Art Plumbing, Air Conditioning, and Electric gets the job done right and fast with emergency service day and night. Fully licensed and insured, plus upfront pricing, convenient financing, and Art's Keep Cool guarantee. So whether installing a new air conditioning system or doing an AC tune-up or fixing your air conditioning emergency, Art is there with what you need. Air conditioner not working? No sweat. Art can fix it.
Now is the time to start thinking about summer camp for your child. And if you live in Palm Beach County, did you know more than 3,000 summer camp scholarships are available for children ages 5 through 17? Want to learn if your child may be eligible for a scholarship to cover all camp costs? Go to everyparentpbc.org/camp. That's everyparentpbc.org/camp. This message brought to you by Children's Services Council of Palm Beach County.
Look, I've seen it many people. They get into middle age and it's really tough for them to lose weight. You need some added help. Dieting and exercise, you don't cut anymore. That's why there's Wellington Anti-Aging. If you've been trying and struggling, don't worry, because they've got just what you need to get that weight off of your body. Just go online to WellingtonAntiAging.com and see everything they have to offer. They've got all the weight loss drugs you need. They've got the anti-aging things like getting rid of wrinkles, getting rid of age spots, anything that makes you look younger. They got all that kind of stuff as well. The thing that I really love going there is their hormone replacement therapy. The reason why is because of how good it makes you feel. It gets you more energy like immediately. Day one, you start feeling it. Your metabolism speeds up. Your libido kicks up. That's awesome. If you've got hot flashes or night sweats from menopause, those go away. And you also fend off long-term health complications like type 2 diabetes, heart disease, even some forms of cancer. So feel better, look better. Go to WellingtonAntiAging.com today.
Mostly cloudy this morning. A few light showers or drizzles, too, as temperatures are in the mid-70s. That's a mild start. Even warmer and humid this afternoon with highs in the mid-80s. But a cold front passing through with very breezy conditions and also a few passing showers this afternoon. I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Jennifer Correa on 97.9 WRMF.
Sponsored by Jackson Hewitt.
Why are people saying hew yeah to Jackson Hewitt? When you switch to Jackson Hewitt, they will beat what you paid last year on tax prep. Even if you filed online. Proof of prior year payment required when filing. New clients only at participating locations through April 7th. Terms at JacksonHewitt.com.
Hit subscribe on our YouTube channel now to follow KVJ and watch KVJ TV. Now back to the KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF.
Sitting on the dock of a bay, wasting time.
Get it, Otis. Just that is get it.
Virginia's nomination for the best whistling song of
that
all time.
That is a groove. That's a vibe. That beats your Billy. That beats your Guns N' Roses.
I mean, no, it does not.
It does.
You have to wait the entire song to get like 5 seconds of whistle. Yeah.
Well, the
it was
song,
like an afterthought.
Until then, the song slaps better than both of y'all.
If you stop close. The song like almost when it's over, like a lot of people do, you never even know it whistles.
They don't even know they have whistling. Yeah.
Whatever. Yeah. That is a whistling legendary song.
I mean, my song starts with whistling. like a canary.
I'm going to sleep over here.
Oh, it's just amazing, man.
Mine That's kicks amazing. You right in the crotch in the good way.
Yours goes on too long with the whistling.
We call that music composition?
Oh, yeah, Billy.
All right, get to the words.
Okay, oh, he does, and his words will rock your mind.
Not more than Otis Redding.
Is there anything that could challenge any of those nominations that we have for the greatest whistling song of all time?
Only one I can think of is
Whistle While You Work or The Bridge Over the River Kwai.
Yeah, I think. Whatever's
I'm
that.
Not sure what you're doing over there. Yeah, that's the Bridge over the River Kwai.
Yeah. Yeah.
And Whistle While You Work.
Yeah, I guess I'm talking more of like a popular.
Gotcha. I'm ruining your bit. My bad.
Yeah.
I mean, you're kind of doing worse than me, and I didn't think you could do worse.
No, Kevin, do a poll. Who's doing worse, Virginia J. Bird? I'm telling you, it's Virginia.
It's a landslide. I'm over here singing like a songbird.
You know when you go to the eye doctor, and they're like, okay, better or worse? Better or worse?
Yes.
What do you think about this? Better or worse?
Worse.
Worse.
Okay, you don't think that's better?
I just don't like Adam Levine. I'm over it.
Okay. Moves Like Jagger doesn't cut it.
Oh, I hate that song.
But I love Jagger.
Okay. Better or worse?
I'm a sucker for you.
Yeah. Worse.
Okay, you're saying worse.
I like that one.
It's worse, though, than okay. Patience or and even your little Dock of the Bay.
Dock of the Bay is top dog.
Okay, what about this one? Better or worse, One Republic's Good Life. It's too simple.
It's overplayed.
It's overplayed.
Like every other song we play.
Okay, all right. This is an alternative song. Have you ever heard of the song Young Folks? I think it was used in some commercials. Peter Bjorn and John.
Oh, I like this. Yeah.
That's a pretty solid whistle song.
Shake it, shake it.
It's not bad.
Okay.
It makes me want to shake my boobies.
Oh, yeah? Well, go right ahead, Virginia. Oh, Daddy's, she is. Look at that.
Daddy's cut to camera two.
Yeah.
Which is Virginia's.
I got a loose bra on. Let's go.
All right. Booby shaking song. All right.
That's fun.
Black Keys did Tighten Up. I can't even really tell that's whistling, though.
It could be a flute of sorts or a keyboard.
More flutish than it is.
I like that groove, though.
It is good. It is good. Foster the People whistles in Pumped Up Kicks.
That's good.
Okay, that's a song whistle. So.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's hard to hate on. And I don't even love that song. That's a good whistle. It's got a good groove.
Yeah.
Okay. That's good.
All right. Well, we got some solid nominations in here now. Thank you very much for texting those in. 877-979-WRMF. Is there another one that we did not mention? You can let us know here on the KVJ show.
Something's got a hold on me lately, though I don't know myself anymore. Feels like the walls are all closing in and the devil's knocking at my door. Whoa, out of my mind. How many times did I tell you I'm no good at being alone? Yeah, it's taking a toll on me, trying my best to keep from tearing the skin off my bones. Don't you know? Break when I'm with you. Yeah, I know I can do it on my
body. Problem is when I'm with you, I'm an addict. And I need some relief. My skin and your teeth. Can't see the forest through the trees. Got me down on my knees, darling, please. Oh, I'm losing control when you're not next to me. I'm
some classics that we forgot. We were talking about the best whistling songs of all time. There was a band back in the 80s called the Jay Giles Band. They did this song called Centerfold.
Okay. Oh, I like that. That's good, too.
They played that so much on MTV, and as a little kid waiting for the part where he plays the drums and it turns into milk. Do you remember that part?
I do remember that, yeah.
I couldn't wait for that part as a kid.
Yeah, it comes bouncing off the drums.
Yeah.
Somebody also said, what about the Bangles? They had a good whistling song and Walks Like an Egyptian. All right, okay. That's a little whistling part there. But the one that got the most votes, would this be the greatest whistling song of all time? You may not think of the Ying Yang Twins when you think about whistling, but they did Whistle While You Twerk.
Oh, yeah. Hit me, Kevin.
Whistle while you twerk. Go ahead and start and make the kick your butt and whistle while you twerk.
Oh, that's amazing.
Winner, okay. There you go. Coming up here in a couple of minutes, what are things that you just won't deal with because you've gotten older? Some great answers we got for you next.
More KVJ next on 87.9 WRMF.
Hard Rock Bet presents Legal in Florida.
You can bet the game on Hard Rock Bet. No more betting inside your head.
A no-regret first bet up to $100 when you sign up now. Offered by the Seminole Tribe of Florida. Must be 21 and over and physically present in Florida to wager. Terms and conditions apply. Concerned about gambling? Please call 1-888-ADMITTED.
Racetrack breakfast made fresh in store. They're the breakfast sandwiches you adore. Fluffy eggs and melted cheese stacked. Bacon or sausage, get your day on track.
Yeah, that tracks. That's a hit that'll get your taste buds nodding.
Get 2 for $5 every day.
Racetrack. Whatever gets you going. Buy 2 classic breakfast sandwiches for $5. Limitations apply. See store for details.
WeBuyAnyCar.com. Why sell your car at WeBuyAnyCar.com? Because when you trade in, you're dealing with a dealer. And sure, they're interested in a good deal. For them, not for you. Come to WeBuyAnyCar.com instead. All we do is buy cars. You get in, get out, and get paid at a fair price. So don't take chances with a trade-in. Go to WeBuyAnyCar.com for a free online valuation.
Find out how much your car's worth at WeBuyAnyCar.com.
You want subs made with high-quality meats and cheeses? You go to Jersey Mike's. You want high-quality radio ideas? You go to me. Like this.
I'm an astronaut on a mission to find water on the moon. But because I'm a genius, I realize that what humanity actually needs in space is high-quality meats and cheeses from Jersey Mike's. Now to figure out how to remove the helmet and eat the sub without my head exploding. Here goes nothing.
Always high-quality meats and cheeses. Jersey Mike's, a sub above.
Victim of a slip and fall? It takes one phone call to take back control of your life. Anajar and Levine will fight to get you the compensation you deserve. Call me, Mark Anajar, for a free consultation. 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
In office, West Palm Beach.
Thank you. dropped an F word before you.
Oh, I didn't know my mic was up.
Your music was playing. I turned it on. There's an F word.
Sorry.
Wow. All right.
Jay Bird distracted me.
Okay. All right. Let me do your commercial.
The team at Cooling Advisors is family owned and operated. If you're looking for an AC team that is going to care about their reputation and therefore care about your AC system, that is Cooling Advisors. Go online today and get this company to come out and look at your AC. Get them to show you all the benefits of joining the Cooling Club like I did. I joined the Cooling Club. You get scheduled regular tune-ups and maintenance of your system twice a year. We love that. And they make sure that you never have any issues. And when you call, they jump. I love that. CoolingAdvisors.com. The company you trust, the company you keep.
If you're unaware, T-Mobile calls themselves the Un-Carrier, which is fitting considering they just unraveled their price lock guarantee for new customers. If you ask me, that's pretty uncool. If you're uncomfortable with a company that says one thing but does another, then switch to Xfinity, whose whole home Wi-Fi, wired internet, service, speed, and reliability are unparalleled. Unjoin the Un-Carrier. Switch to Xfinity today. Now through April 21st, new customers can get 300 megabits per second Xfinity Internet for $35. And ask how you can save 40% over T-Mobile in your first year. Switch today. Go to Xfinity.com/TMOFAX, call 1-800-XFINITY, or visit a store today. Requires paperless billing and auto pay with stored bank account and a one-year contract. Connect more Internet versus T-Mobile home Internet. $60 a month. Regular pricing applies after promo period. Restrictions apply. Taxes and fees extra. Actual speeds vary. Effective for new customers after 1/17/2024. T-Mobile's price lock will only reimburse your last bill if you terminate service due to a price increase.
A true partner in your health dedicates time to understanding your needs. At Conviva Care Center, doctors make one-on-one time with you a priority so you can get all your questions answered and feel more confident in your health care. Conviva Senior Care experts have been helping seniors stay healthy and independent for more than 50 years. Schedule a tour today at tourconviva.com. That's tourconviva.com.
Our friend Spiro with the Good Greek Enterprises has been our marketing partner now for 20 plus years. That's a relationship that goes way longer than most marriages. My friend Spiro can help you with every detail of your move from beginning to end, real estate, mortgages, financing. He can help you with moving, storing, insurance. I mean, you name it, he does it.
Yeah, they do everything so well. My family has used them, had great experiences, and that's why Good Greek has one of the highest referral rates for moving companies of its size in the whole state of Florida.
We need Good Greek for my Jeep. I've got our whole costume closet stuck in there, and someone said, you should get Good Greek to come get this all out of here. I go, yeah, you're right. What am I thinking?
They could store it all for us and keep it safe. And I love the fact that when they come to move your stuff, their trucks have cameras on them so you can see their stuff, GPS tracking on them, so you know where your stuff is. Like, that is peace of mind, and that's the way the Good Greek is going to get our business. Go online and choose the right company. Go to goodgreek.com because it's all Good Greek to us.
Injured in an accident? Visit Lytle Rider Smith Ivy and Fronrath at foryourrights.com.
When you need a laugh, you need our mobile app. Download it free. Just search 97.9 WRMF. Now back to the KVJ show on 97.9 WRMF.
I can tell you, there is real peace in getting a little bit older. The things that you used to stress yourself out with when you were younger, you realize really doesn't matter. You become more comfortable in your own skin. You don't get FOMO. You don't feel like you got to be out every single Friday and Saturday night. And there's something awesome about that. So BuzzFeed was asking, is there something you no longer want to deal with as you have gotten older?
Humans.
A lot of the theme is that.
Again, I think a lot of people love a subset of humans. I think overall, and I think it's a lot to do with just everyone seems to be bickering and no one could ever be on the same page. I think that annoys people, and that's why there's an attitude sometimes against humans the older you get.
When I was younger, I think I used to feel like I had to have a stable of 20 friends. And then all loved me at all times. And then I think as you get older, you're like, you know what? I'm good with two.
Well, yeah, and I think you also realize you're just not gonna change people's minds, or they're not gonna be on your side no matter how hard you try.
It was explained to me this week by somebody. There's mean people out there, and you're not gonna change those mean people, so don't try. But also, don't let mean people change you. You got to just be you and be nice and go about your day and don't let the mean people change who you are.
There are people listening right now that would be mean to us for talking about mean people. and the cycle just continues.
But you got to just laugh at them and not let them shake you. And I think that was something that I struggled with when I was younger. But now that I'm older, I'm just like, yeah, they're mean and they're not changing me. You just go be mean over there. Good luck with karma.
And I bring up humans because I've heard a lot of other people say that for an answer. But I don't want you to think it's subsets. You like, y'all are awesome. The subsets is great.
You, when you find your tribe, you are lucky. And you got to stick with that tribe.
Mm-hmm. This one person said, I prefer solitude to spending time with somebody that I find uninteresting, even if they're very nice. You become more selective on the people that you spend your time with.
Definitely.
I think you do that with just your time in general, the longer you're on the rock.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Another person said, I don't do anything recreationally anymore. If I'm not enjoying myself, like a movie or a show, I turn it off. And if I'm not having fun at a party, I just leave.
You know what? I got a buddy who said, I've officially quit playing video games. I used to love them, but I just found myself always rage quitting and getting mad. I wasn't even enjoying them. So he retired from video games because he couldn't handle it.
It's good, though, that he assessed the situation and said, what am I getting out of this?
I told him, bro, just put it on beginner mode. Beginner mode rules.
One person said, I don't put it up with relationship drama anymore. If they want to do anything that's kind of exhausting, I just pull the plug. I'm like, I don't need it.
You don't need it.
Man.
Drama is for your 20s. Drama, once you get into your 30s and 40s, you're like, I don't need this crap.
Especially if it's in the beginning.
Yes.
If it's in the beginning of you getting to know somebody or dating somebody and they're already giving you some drama, pull that plug.
Bye.
Pull it.
Bye.
Another person said, you know what? I just don't want to deal with this kind of stuff anymore. Like in traffic, it used to be a competition. I don't spend time arguing with people anymore. Look, if you're trying to cut in aggressively, go right ahead.
Go.
You know, letting things like this go makes my day better.
So, I don't care if you cut around me in your Nissan because you think it's a BMW and it's not.
Yeah.
Go, Nissan, go.
But if you are struggling with something and you want to let it go, it's so easy to say, just let it go. But how do you apply that? How do you make yourself
let something
go? You got to
check yourself. In the moment, you have to check yourself.
Yeah,
as soon as you feel your blood pressure like going up a little bit, you go, wait a minute. What am I doing here? I'm letting this person control my mood? Oh, hell no.
But you think that's just all you have to do to let something go? Isn't there a series of things? I just think it's a blanket statement to say, just let it go. It would be cool
if
someone would give you
one, two, three things identifying
to do.
That you
identify.
Are
when you letting yourself get out of hand, identify.
Mm-hmm. Somebody else said, you know, as I've gotten older, I don't want to deal or be bullied into some of these family functions. And I'm talking about extended family things that I don't really want to do. I got my own little tribe, my own little family here, and we prefer to do things. I'm okay with saying, I'm sorry.
I've done it. They all hate me, and I'm so at peace with it.
Right. You're good with it, right?
I don't even know them.
Yeah.
Up north?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, Rhode Island?
Yeah.
I don't care about them.
Stick it.
Somebody else said, you know how somebody, you go to a function, it's a gathering, and somebody made it, and they want you to eat it, and you don't like it, or it's not on your diet, or whatever you want to do, and you're just trying to be nice? Don't do that anymore.
We work with somebody like that at one of...
Oh, if I made it, you better eat it.
But
if I made it, you better eat it.
We work with somebody like that, and I would get bullied in the hallway to eat some crappy stuff. And if you didn't eat, she would not let you go. She'd almost kind of block the hallway until you ate it.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. I want you to try my stuff.
And as you get older, I have noticed this too. People who are saying, yeah, you know what? Standing in the lawn is not as awesome as it used to be. If I'm going to go to a concert, I'm going to get seats.
That is a true statement right there.
Mm-hmm.
I love a seat.
Yep.
I love a cup holder.
Right.
Mama likes to stretch them legs.
You're not lying, man.
I am not built for sitting Indian style.
I saw the police from the lawn, and Sting looked like a bug.
Yeah,
it was
right.
So small.
The point is down.
I might as well just watch it on YouTube.
Right, exactly. All right, coming up here in a couple of minutes, since we are just so evolved, older and wiser now, Jaber's going to sprinkle a little bit more wisdom on you. His thought for the day is coming up next.
But they saw what I saw. They were far the way I felt, but they don't know what you want. And baby, I would never tell. If they knew what I know, they would never let you go. So guess what? I ain't never letting you go. Cause your lips were made for mine, and my heart would go flatline if it wasn't beating for you all the time. So if I get jealous, can't help it. I want every bit of you. I guess I'm selfish. It's bad for my mental, but I can't fight it when you're out looking like you do. But you can't hide it. No. Put you in a frame. Oh, baby, who could blame you? Glad your mama made you. Making me insane. You cannot be explained. Oh, you must be an angel. Every time the phone rings, I hope that it's you on the other side. I wanna tell you everything, everything that's on my mind. And I don't want any other guys taking my place, girl. I got too much pride. I know I may be wrong, but I don't wanna be right. Cause your lips were made for mine, and my heart would go flatline if it wasn't beating for you all the time. So if I get jealous, I can't help it. I want every bit of you. I guess I'm selfish. It's bad for my mental, but I can't fight it when you're out looking like you do. But you can't hide it, no. Put you in a frame, oh baby, who could blame you? Glad your mama made you. Making me insane, you. So if I get jealous, I can't help it. I want every bit of you. I guess I'm selfish. It's bad for my mental, but I can't fight it when you're out looking like you do. But you can't hide it, no. Put you in a frame, oh baby, who could blame you? Glad your mama made you. You must be an angel. Jealous, but I can't help it. I want every bit of you. I guess I'm selfish.
More KVJs on the way on the app of the show. You can check it out on YouTube. Also on Twitch. Go to either platform. Look for the KVJ show in just about 15 minutes. It's also always on demand or wherever you get your podcasts. Places like Spotify. KVJ is there. Bird. Why don't you wrap it up with your thought for the day?
I normally don't get political, but I want to make this one political.
Oh, sweet. Oh. Okay. I love politics.
Ask not what you can do for your country.
Yeah.
Ask what's for lunch.
Okay. All right.
Yeah,
that's good. I like it.
The KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF.